Era puxa,
with my support, me yelling at shit like last night, you could go for it in my voice. Did you watch it last night? Did you hear me last night?
What?
I was the last person here.
And what went on
there? The whole match.
I didn't hear you, I watched it,
mate. Oh, you didn't understand it. You gotta watch it again, you listen to it.
You did that?
Yeah.
You're scared,
huh? I love you. I love you. You guys are good.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We have reached semi-final time in the Big Guns, men's and ladies. We're not far off kicking off now. Joining me in commentary is Paul Pike for the first time this weekend. How are you, Pikey?
Yeah, not too bad. Have we got a show for everyone tonight?
Mate, it's... I'm going to touch on it real quick before we get into the matches. Mick Hill's drawn Joel Younger. Now, both these guys didn't lose, so they both had a double chance all the way to this point where we basically throw the double chance out the window. And they've drawn each other, and I think Joel's probably a little bit hard done by.
Yeah, so it is straight knockout now. This is the semi-finals. Winner of this, straight through to the final.
And on the other side of the coin, Colby Poole had a double chance still, and maybe I think Renata did too. Yes, Renata did too. So the two double chance players have actually drawn each other on both the men's and the women's. Now, at the end of these matches, so we'll just let Trav talk. I'm going to try and interview some players after the completion of these matches, and I'm also going to try and get Travis in the interview box as well, just to get his thoughts on the tournament, how it's run, and semi-throw him under the bus, just with a couple of questions he probably isn't going to like, but I'm all about the controversy and the improvement of everything in pool, so I don't ever bring up controversy to cause drama. I do it to create discussion and try and make things move forward. That's my aim. Anyone that thinks otherwise can tune off right now.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of great things about this tournament. I mean, probably apart from the Western National, it's like the biggest tournament in Australia, and I just hope it can get bigger and better every year.
Well, just to recap, I think there's three things that need to change for next year. Number one, bring the satellites in. Do the same thing as the Western National. I think it's huge. There is going to be that many top-line players play next year. You've got this New Zealand crowd that's come over.
They're keen to come back.
Insane. And you've got English guys who come over, and every one of them said, I'm coming back. All right? And even if they've got to pay their own way.
Yep.
You're going to get other people just showing up, going, well, I want to be part of this. And the number of amateurs that are going to be able to play is going to be decreased because of it.
Yeah.
Bring the satellites in, generate more money from the satellites like Ron Kelly did. And I'll touch on the other two later. We've got the match underway. And no surprises at all, Pikey. Mick Hill has potted ball off the break.
I haven't seen him miss one for the last two or three matches, I think.
But probably for the first time in a while, the break wasn't favourable to clear off at the first visit. So he's just...
weighed up.
Yeah. And it was pretty lackadaisical too, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was interesting. I think he clipped the black on the way through. He wanted to get it down neat over the hole.
Joel's... I think Joel's tried to pot that, to be honest. I think he wanted to sit this yellow over the kick, but the angle, he wanted to sort of make sure he cleared the yellow as well.
So... ball up on the top left there for Mix.
We're probably going to focus more on the men's game. There's two reasons for that. There's an excellent chance it'll finish quicker, given the aggression and how often they do basically pot out off the break. And number two, it is seriously, how do you not watch the number one player in the world? Whenever you get the chance. We're blessed for it. So, and it's great to watch our Aussie guys having a crack at knocking him off.
We will give you updates on the other match too, the Rusty and Jake, and the other women's match, which is Lauren Jelly and Lyndall Morfitt.
I don't reckon Joel's going to be over the moon about that shot, because he's left his yellow in such a way where he can't pot it. And it could hurt him later on in this frame. It's funny though, my eyes will be casting over watching Colby in there, because obviously, there's an obvious reason why I'm watching it.
She doesn't mind a post-mortem either of the match, does she?
Look, she's a fan. But, I mean, at the end of the day, she does it because she's so passionate. She wants to learn.
Yeah.
The only criticism I'd ever give her about her post-mortem is sometimes when she is actually presented with, you know, maybe a different way she could have gone, she sort of gets obsessed and tunnel vision on trying to explain the reasoning for why she went the way she did, when that's not the point of the exercise if you're trying to increase your knowledge.
Yeah, it is hard like that. It's human nature, really, to defend your actions, you know what I mean?
Exactly right.
And the biggest key to improving is listening to other people and taking on board what they're saying. And
Mick's just tried to extract the red there, and he's probably, I would have to say, he's probably been a little unfortunate to not get some separation at least. So he's got to basically go to plan B now, because that was plan A to basically finish that visit. Now he's got to go to plan B and probably look to cover this pocket. It's not easy. Look how well he's played that.
That is
actually, yeah, it's like, oh, it's people are like, oh, not hard, he just put the ball out of the pocket. But you've actually got to hit it spot on at that angle, exactly right. And he's got it neat as well. There's another problem. See, he's going to pop the red, right? And this is something I really like, that Joel has drawn Mick Hill, because he's not afraid to do that. I reckon, like, for example, Rusty, okay, of the four players, I think Rusty would be hesitant to foul there and give the two, because he's just thinking, well, Mick's just going to pot out no matter what with the two shots. You know what I mean? And I think Joel has basically said, you know what, Mick, you're hot out, good on you. There's no way I was winning the frame of that red over the hole. I couldn't do anything about it. I'm just going to make it difficult for you. If you pot out, you pot out.
I think the really good thing with this matchup is we'll see a lot of good pool play, like not so much, you know, just outages. We'll see some good battles where good shot selection.
Yeah, exactly right. And that's a great opening pot there from Mick. And it basically what it's done is kept the out alive. If he had a miss out, the out was gone, probably, most likely. But looking maybe for a kick shot now. Be surprised if he takes the bottom right ball first, purely because it's going to be his backup ball off his ball he's about to kick out now.
It's also, you can use that red to get round behind the black.
I think he's going to screw off it, is he? And pull the white out of it? He tried to pull it out. He hit it too thick on the bottom side, sorry, the top side as you look at the table, the red. If you hit it the bottom side, and you could have screwed the white sort of back out and held for the bottom red. He's still got an opportunity though. It's by no means easy. Right. He's actually got to pot this and land pretty much on the balk line or slightly higher of it so he can come offside cushion and then in behind the black.
Doesn't want to be short on it.
Tough shot this.
He's losing a side.
Swinging around, is he?
He's tried to open the black up.
Oh, that.
Have a look at the position.
I'm sorry, folks. That is complete rubbish luck. That's all that is. There's no way he's played for that. And he's extremely fortunate not to pot the yellow as well.
No, I think he tried to move the black there.
Yeah, for sure. Very, very fortunate to even have such a clean shot. But the funniest part is he might be dead straight, can't do anything with it.
He's looking at screwing off the side of the yellow.
It might be the only shot.
How good would that shot be?
If he actually gets his shot right and he lands on the black, we're going to turn the stream off and go home, to be honest. We've already got our result.
He nearly did.
That was a tough shot.
Wasn't far off.
He actually, that shot there, if he was to commentate his own shot there, he'll say that he belted the white there, he didn't cue it as well as he needed to get the flick.
Yeah.
Really fine line between belting the white to get the reaction and cueing it really sweetly to get that zip.
Now he's looking at potting this off the yellow.
He's looking to what?
Pot the black off the edge of the yellow.
This is thin as hell. This will be some shot as well. It's amazing, you know, you're watching here and you can never count him out even when he looks like he's got no chance. Look, let's be fair, it's a pretty good effort.
He'll be filthy, though.
He will be filthy. He probably would have thought he'd get that 8 out of 10. But Joel needs to capitalise. That is not the way to start. That's not a good shot.
That is a poor shot.
I don't know what was wrong with just playing for the two balls in the middle there. You had all this variance. You could have landed low, high, and you still would have had one of the two. And the other one, you could have transitioned from one to the other quite easily. Yeah. And at the very worst, you could have had one at the top. So I don't like that shot from Joel. And it's unlike Joel, too, to move the white more than he really needs to. I really want to see this ball go in. That's a super shot from Joel.
Yeah, he's not a bad cuist either, Joel, is he?
No, he's a very good cuist. Come on, Russ. Now, question now. Do you take this ball at the top? I don't think you can afford to play it plain ball, Pikey. It looks like it's going to go a bit close to the middle.
I like the one into the middle and come around the back three angles, but I don't know.
Oh, well, Renato's just popped the black out of turn, and Colby's got first blood in a very unorthodox fashion. I like this shot here, Pikey, but you've got to swing the white, so he's going to be using a bit of bottom and right-hand side here. Great shot.
That is a great shot.
Now, one more good screwback shot. All in the middle. Or is he going to top through this? He might have more angle than I thought.
Run through with a little bit of side.
Yeah, he's running through. He's got a fair bit of angle. Maybe just straight top spin. Oh, he stunned it.
Yeah, probably a bit tense in the arm.
Yeah, he didn't hit high enough on the white, and he's sort of punched it rather than cued through it.
That can happen when you tense up on the cue, that kind of shot.
Yeah, you grip it at the end and clench it. Absolutely.
You lose the reaction.
I have very good experience of doing that. I do it all the time. Just play the accidental stun run through and don't get any action on the white whatsoever. Yeah. Fall short.
And I think you notice that in a lot of pressure situations near the end of matches and frames, players come up short a lot. And it's often because of that fact, because they're tense.
No, that's not in. And I mentioned last night that Robbo, when he played Mickey, had to take every chance available to him to win the match. Yeah. That was a chance right there to win, like basically to strike.
And it's
and this sounds really bad, me saying this, but this match is already over. Because he didn't take every chance he possibly could.
They are massive, you know, can change the whole direction of a match.
And it can. I feel sick for Joel there.
You know, one bloke's confidence goes up, one bloke's goes down. And so it's 1-1 with Jake and Rusty.
Colby's not on a yellow. I'm going to assume that she's going to screw off this ball in the middle and try and get her bad boy out straight away. I actually don't think that's the right shot. I would play the ball on the bottom first and get an angle on the yellow to tumble the top rail into it. It's a much easier shot to play. So she could play that shot 10 times and she'll screw back 10 different directions. You know what I mean? She might hit the pack. Even if she hits them, she might not develop it.
Hard to control as well. And you've got to be on the ball.
Exactly. Yeah, I would much rather use the ball in the middle with angle to come off the bottom row. And you can actually use left-hand side as well to really make that angle a greater area to hit.
Okay, Mick's got a choice here. Yellows look pretty good.
No, gee, there's frames over. Can't dump the white either. There's sort of many compounds without you even realising. You know, Joel wins that frame, probably doesn't dump the white, gets this spread himself.
Yeah.
It's just, that's amazing. Still getting used to people saying 20 seconds instead of 30 seconds. Whoa, what's happened there? That's a little fortunate.
Just got a message off Kev Harvey. I'll say g'day, he's watching the stream.
You know, I may have got one myself. Oh, Kev's just sent me a quote. It's very unlike Kev to send quotes with intelligence. No, I'm just kidding there, Kev. He sent one and he says, the more I practice, the luckier I become.
Yeah.
I don't know if that always holds true, Kev.
I think there's a lot to that, you know. I don't know if it's, I wouldn't call it luck, but I think it comes with attitude too. You see positives or some people see negatives, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I completely agree with that. You keep telling yourself you're the luckiest player in Australia. You probably will be coming.
Yeah. And I mean, it's the same in life. You can have all sorts of horrible things happen or all sorts of good things, and some blokes can be miserable and some can be happy.
Yeah, it's how you cop it on the chin. And Mick's looking pretty out here, and Colby has done the old, I'm going to throw all my eggs in one single basket on a very large shot.
Big back double.
She has overheated it a bit, but the fact that she's left it till last, she could have put the ball over the hole, but I think Colby's initial intention is aggression. And I have no issues with that, but at that particular point, I probably would have set the ball over the hole. That's missed, and the worst part for Colby, it's gone dead as a doornail.
Dead.
And Mick Hill he's actually played a horrible positional shot and made that black look as straightforward as possible.
How smooth does he make those difficult shots?
He actually annoys the hell out of me. He plays fine cuts really smoothly.
But the pace that he plays them, like, it's just so much control. And you're on an angle that you think you've got no control.
You're not a violent man, are you, Pikey? You want to punch him, don't you?
No, I'm not. I want to run down and high-five him.
You want to run down and high-five him? I want to punch him. I'm just kidding. So, very rare to see Renata lose frames from this position. She is one of the best all-round female players in the country. Has both games, loves to attack the game, but also has a very, very good B game.
What's Shout out to Big Jez as well. Hope you're enjoying the show.
I actually asked Rusty in my interview with him before he played. Who did he play last match?
Rusty played last night, wasn't
he? Andy Barnett. I asked him if he was going to do any live Facebook status updates while he was in the middle of his match, but he decided he's going to give that away.
I think he only does that when he's struggling, doesn't he? Tries to G himself up.
I've never seen anything like it. It was actually quite funny. Colby's actually got a chance here. Difficult one at that, but if she can actually make contact with his yellow and get it over the hole.
That's right, mate.
Well, pot it, of course. She'll move herself into a good contention. This is a tough shot, though. Probably needs a
little
touch.
Bit of run
probably
inside.
Needs some side, yeah. Just missed. That's a good effort, though, you've got to admit.
Okay, we've got a game of pool going on here with Mick and Joel. Mick's actually just potted Joel's ball. Crazy.
What's he on reds, Joel?
Mick just ran the yellow down onto the red over the right-hand corner. So Joel's got two on the red.
I reckon this red goes, it's just above and to the left of the white, goes in the middle. But to what advantage that holds, I do not know.
Can he play this off the yellow, or is he too thin? He's played this trickle in.
Probably just because he couldn't hit it. And I don't think we'll see him sit it deep in the pocket, because Joel's probably likely to pot it as well.
You mean Mick?
Oh, sorry, Mick.
Yeah. Renata's just missed that red. That was...
Wow. And she's left Colby. So I tell you what, I've watched Colby a fair share of luck already this tournament. Like she's destined to win this tournament.
That was uncharacteristic there.
Gotta hit them, Colby. Gotta hit them.
That's one thing with Mick Hill, he always gets right up on the shot, doesn't he? He doesn't underhit things.
I still expect Colby to pot this, but you've got to get into them and get another foot closer off the rail.
Yeah, people, they end up with sort of a dodgy shot on the black that's a half missable where, you know, Mick gets up, makes the shot easy. His position's class, though.
Even though when it's not like that, black he landed on that last frame was a terrible position shot, but he just still potted with ease.
Yeah.
She has
potted. Oh, no.
I take back everything I said about her having some luck. That was pretty unfortunate. Yeah. And what's actually really interesting about this frame is Renata's pot the black out of turn first frame, Colby's pot the black and pot Renata's ball in the second frame, return the favour, one all. We're going to play race to seven really now.
Well, they got the nervous ones out the way anyway, Jamie.
Look, that was a good pot. And do you know what's actually really interesting about that? If we were to replay that, you'll actually see Colby didn't pot that black clean as a whistle. And it actually created the angle to pot the red.
Yeah.
So had she pot it clean, that wouldn't have happened.
She's got a wry smile on her face anyway.
Oh, as long as she's not stressing out about it, she'll be fine. So you'll actually see, Dan's actually just getting a replay up of it. Here we go, watch this. Oh, what am I talking about? She's hit it clean as a whistle, I'm an idiot. Never mind, that shot was just on. Bad shot, Colby. She cued it clean as you can cue it. Just found the angle. Look at this shot coming up.
Oh.
I think he's filthy that he hasn't made the yellow one. That word means, Blakey. Which is shame. Kev's just sending the quotes through like you wouldn't believe, and I do not know what the word indomitable means.
Indomitable.
Indomitable. Oh, you even know how to pronounce it, Blakey. You obviously know what it means. What does it mean? Do you know?
Unshakable, I believe.
Unshakable.
I'm not sure if that's the correct definition.
Kev, can you Facebook message me and tell me what indomitable means? And if you have to look it up yourself, you had no right sending us that quote. Look at this shot. That is a top class shot. He's like, hey, Joel, you can have the only ball you can hit, that one. But I'm pretty sure Joel's going to go up and down here. He's on red, yeah?
Where are we?
Up and down. Yeah, it's crazy.
It was a great shot.
Wow, Joel's going to flick off this. He might be able to hit it. I still like the up and down, but actually, no, this is probably more percentage.
He's trying to land on that ball. He's landed on it.
Very on it.
Not quite what he wanted, but.
Go on, mate.
What do you reckon, Jamie, the little drop spooker?
Yeah, it's, and this is another really weird thing about playing someone like McHugh. You snooker and you're wondering what they're going to do to ruin it.
To ruin it. Oh, hang on.
I don't mind this shot from Joel.
I don't like it.
Oh, I don't like it anymore.
I don't like it.
I do not like it now. Had to stay over the hole, that red.
Yeah.
The thought process I understand very well, just the execution hasn't come off as planned.
Does he play this into the back of the red that's against the yellow, or does he go the other side? Or does he play it into the front ring?
I'll tell you one thing, you'd be wishing he was off the rail a little bit, because then he could actually punch it.
I like playing it into the back red, but we'll see what he does.
I like playing it. Yeah, I agree with that, but I don't reckon he will. Yeah, he's gone that way. He's actually tried to hit it thicker and open up the yellow. How funny is it, though? Even the best in the world, when they're queuing off the rail and they've got to hit it at a pace, they tend to move a bit on the shot. Yeah. He sort of jumped up off of that.
Well, it wasn't an easy shot.
No, exactly. And I've also noticed Mick had obviously three different shirts on, and he has ripped off the sponsors and whacked them on each shirt every time. Because he had a big gun shirt on the other day, so
yeah.
And now the little sponsors down the front.
I notice he's got PK Landscaping on the back. I'm sure there'd be some heavy exchange of dollars there.
No, I think that was... Pete has actually just done all the running around for Mick for his shows.
Yeah,
he's done lots of K's and stuff, so...
Pete looks after Mick every time he comes over.
Yeah, he picks him up from the airport and stuff, and we encourage Mick to maybe give Pete a few bucks for that, because I don't think he has yet.
Oh, he might, if we don't know that.
Not afraid to keep the money in his wallet, as Mick Hill.
Come on, buddy.
How was it the year that he, when he won the Anzac tunnel, we asked him to put some money over the bar, and as soon as he opened up his wallet, about 25 fruit bats flew out of it.
Little defensive shot there, pop the red.
You know what? And this is all about the whole push shot thing. Tell me you can't push through this and open everything up here. You're going to need a little bit of luck.
Yeah, so he's probably not used to that with the
English style. I'd be just English smashing style. Through this if it was me.
See?
So I don't...
Joel's tried to kill the black, I think.
Come on, Joel.
I just love the smash through there. You're in trouble. You might as well just open them up.
Yeah,
there's no way that yellow goes along the rail, because it's hitting the other one. They're just going to all explode out.
I was not a big fan of Joel's shot there.
Well, he's killed the red.
And the black.
The black I don't mind, but the red, like, this is, you've got another shot and you've really got nothing.
He didn't really advance or...
He made his position worse, is what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
And I don't believe it's not in Mick's nature to know the push shot, because before he played snooker, he was an 8-ball player. Way before he started playing snooker, he was an 8-ball player before he even touched a snooker table.
Yeah, but
a lot of people might not realise that about Joel.
But, you're talking about Joel, yeah.
Thank you.
Come on, Joel.
Okay, so that is actually a horrible shot to view, but he's actually tried to push the red and on the other one and kill the yellow. And it's still risky for Mick to have a go here. Joel's still going to persist with killing this yellow, and he kind of has to.
It's pretty good.
Well, I don't like it.
It's something, though, you know.
Oh, sorry, now he's got two shots. I'd still smash these two, red and yellow. I'd still get them out of there. I'm pretty confident they don't plant.
He's potting the next ball, I think.
And he's going to run through.
Yeah, great.
You know why I'm on that shot either. As long as it's not a foul snooker.
Yeah, I mean...
Well, that's what we're wondering.
Nah, it's not.
I mean, we don't know what gap is between the yellow and the white.
He hasn't called for it.
Oh, I can see it from... Yeah, okay, it's okay.
Okay.
Now he's going to come from the back side rail and go in behind the yellow.
So he's made that ball potable, and now he's going to leave Joel hard up behind the yellow. Do you drop this over the hole, or...?
I think you have to play the shot Mick's looking at. You can't just drop it over the hole, because your other yellow's still dead. You might as well try and pick up another two.
You can actually separate this yellow and red a bit as well, and still get the snooker. No.
Come on, Joel. Come on, man.
What I like about that shot, he's forced Joel to move the red.
Yeah, that's right. Joel, if Joel moves this red off the yellow...
Like, you have to open that message. Brett Rogers, the king, has just sent Pikey a message. You can't not read it. What does it say?
He was just having an opinion on...
Great hit, mate, great hit.
Who's going to win the match?
What do you say, Joel? Millions and drifting. The only person really in Australia that can beat Mick Hill is Brett Rogers. Everybody knows that.
Well, I think Alec Evrenardis is the only one who has actually beat him in a...
I'm talking race to 11, but yes, we can't take Alec. We can't take credit away for Alec for that. Well, what was that, a race to four?
Race to four or five, yeah, in the Anzac comp.
I'm pretty sure it was four. I think it was a semi-final or a quarter-final or something like that.
I think...
It's been interesting this frame because you've watched Mick manipulating his yellows in a position where he can pot out. But then you're kind of watching Joel try and keep himself alive, knowing that he's falling further and further behind in the frame. I'll tell you what though, if this is touching... Well, of course it's a foul, he's on reds.
Yeah. Like you say, if it's touching, though, he can, move the yellow and put the red back over the pocket,
yeah,
maybe.
I'd be bumping the yellow towards the black, try and kill it. This is actually a huge call right now.
He could even...
I think Travis said yes. I think Travis said yes, it's touching ball, so he can hit the yellow here. You can't hit it thin to the rail, you're going to go in off. So you might as well play it as good as you can.
What about screw off it and then put the red back over that corner?
But then you're punching the yellow away from there, it doesn't become as important. I'll just try and get it resting on the black. Well, he's decided to just bring it away from the play completely. That's not bad. That's not bad. See, if I'm Joel now...
You cover up the other yellow.
Well, I'd play the middle of the three reds and I'd just play it off the bottom rail and bump it in line with the yellow and leave the white ball hard up on the rail, and there's no way Mick's going to be able to get back on that other ball. That's even better. As long as he hasn't left Mick a shot at that yellow.
It's a great shot.
I think Colby's feeling a little bit rushed with the 20-20 on this particular shot.
Yeah, a lot of the players aren't used to this 20-20.
Yeah, she rushed a shot too. It was a tough shot. But you can just tell she was a little bit not comfortable with how much time she had on it. So Mick could hit that yellow, so that's unfortunate for Joel because that would have helped. But he can kind of play the same shot again right now and get the snooker this time.
Yeah.
But actually, you know what? I don't want a snooker in here. If you leave enough angle for Mick to go off the top rail in behind the yellow, it is a disaster. You know what, Pike, you're going to call me crazy. I know these pockets and they're bloody tough. I'm half tempted to play this red on the left-hand side and put the white ball on the side cushion.
I did actually think of that. And to pot it and get back on the yellow is a massive
shot.
Yeah,
it's huge, especially on these pockets. They're so tight. But Giles at least made sure that he hasn't left a snooker. But the problem is, if Mick just runs this ball up, and it's over the hole, what can Joel do to keep him from potting our next shot? Because the yellow's available.
You know what he just looked at then? He looked at actually coming off the side cushion and potting the yellow, so the white drifts out, and he's got a shot on the yellow if it goes in. I reckon he's going off the side cush.
Oh, I reckon you're right, Pike, and that shot's off its head.
Yeah, that's what he tried to do.
He did too. That's off it. Or did he? Did he just try and bring it back in?
No, I've seen him, because he looked at where the white was going to be out here off it.
I don't know. The way he played that, he would have got a lot closer to it than that.
Yeah.
You know he would have. I reckon he's played for that shot. I reckon he's tried to just bring it in play and kill the white.
Well,
I just don't reckon he wanted the yellow to go on the back.
We'll ask him later. I think he was looking it off the cush to pot it.
I reckon you're off your head. I did like the merit in the shot, but you think about it, right? If you don't get that shot right, there is a huge chance you hit the jaws, you're going to kill the yellow on the bottom rail.
Oh,
he did not want that in. This is a really good white. Well, look at this curving in. Jesus. Let's just put Joel on a touch of bother here.
How thin a clip can you get on the red and run back up into ball?
Well, you know what? That is the shot you have to play, though, Pike. And you're right, that's a tough shot. But he's got a snooker background as well. Like, he has played a lot of snooker. And there's a common snooker shot. And he's played it well.
Great shot.
You cannot play that shot. You cannot play that shot given the position you're put in any better.
Yeah, that was a great shot.
Who won that frame though? I missed it.
Still got a lot of work to do though.
Colby looks filthy. I don't think she won it.
Oh, Mick played it.
Oh! Come on, Joel. Come on, buddy.
Hasn't this been an entertaining frame just to watch the options and the choice of shot and. It's not all about potting sometimes, folks.
Is this red on? Can he get the other red out?
You reckon this red's on? Oh, I'll tell you what, Pikey.
He's rubbing his head.
That's close.
He's having a look.
That's close. If you can get it just inside over the hole, and it may be good enough.
And you get a half ball contact on the other red and...
I'd be happy with this over the pocket, to be completely honest. He's not even playing, is he? Oh, he is.
No, I don't think he is. You're right.
Playing on the inside one and going around the angles. Oh, it's a disaster. He thought, oh, you know what? I'll go in off as well. I didn't want to leave him a foul snooker.
Yeah.
And Mick Hill has ended up winning the...
So after that big battle.
Battle of tactics, the battle of will. And you know what? It's half the time a tactical battle is just as much about the execution.
Oh,
look at this. That was actually completely lazy from Mick. That's all that was completely lazy. And he's actually put his chalk on the table. He's fouled.
It's not.
He's put it on the bed of the table. It's a foul. It's a foreign object on the table.
It's not a foul.
I'm just kidding.
But maybe that comes from not being used to these pockets and just reverting back to what he's used to.
You so often see when two players have a tactical frame and then suddenly they've got a pot of ball or, you know, they're presented with a pot, they just forget to pot it. They just don't pot it.
The concentration goes, yeah.
And that was just pure laziness, that's all it was. He's done the white. And this is a huge chance for Joel, obviously,
wow,
to revert. That is what you actually call a massive strawberry.
A massive strawberry.
I actually don't like where Joel's put this wide either. I would much rather put this further across. Probably about like 3 inches off the side rail here.
I'd be rolling this up pocket weight. That's what I'd be doing.
You want to put it over the hole, don't you? Yeah, I don't want this to go in. I'd much rather sit over the hole. It's 10 times easier to make the out. Just screw off this. Why would you do that? I mean, he's just got a huge result there, but why would you do that?
But that's the risk, you know what I mean?
Maybe he's just trying to get going.
You don't need to do that.
Maybe he's just trying to get his arm cueing, getting through the ball. To me, it was just a strange option.
Joel's got a little bit of an angle, I think.
Yeah, he's okay, I think.
If not, he'll reverse side it off the side push.
I don't know why I tried to come back so far. Like, being near the middle pocket was the perfect angle, really.
Yeah.
I think he'll be able to screw off it okay.
Yeah, off the side cushion out.
Yeah, he's got right out. He's on the board now. He'll be feeling a little bit better. He's got a huge strawberry. Have a look at Mick Hill's face. I'm telling you now, he is cutting himself to pieces with a knife inside. Meanwhile, Colby at the table. Not sure about this red at the top of the table near the yellow, whether it will pass anywhere, but that is a large problem ball. Pretty sure the red near the black passes bottom right. Not sure what Colby's thought process here is positional wise, because this is tricky to judge. She judged it well though.
Nice double kiss there.
She might even have an angle to get up on this. Well, if it goes in the middle, which she's just sussing out now, she needs to get, well, pretty much as straight as she can on it.
Yeah.
Or just low so she can come through. But you're better off overhitting this and under it, because you don't want an angle going in the yellow. There's no way in your position. But at least if you overhit it, you might be able to come down the side of the table and play it in the middle. Got the lines working. Tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, Dan has just shown me, and this could have been to everyone's detriment, that we can now draw lines on the table, Blakey.
Hell no.
They're not going to be straight lines.
We might let Dan draw the lines and we tell him where to draw.
It will be Mr. Squiggle having an epileptic fit, but it will be a line of some sort. Is this on that Colby's playing? Oh no. Well, this is not good for Colby at all.
That has landed horrible too. I'm not sure what's going on that potting fest over there with Jake and Rusty, but it's 4-2.
And I'll tell you what, hasn't it just suddenly gone ultra quiet in the room? What has changed? It's dead silent in here, Pikey. Renata's putting the clamps on. She's saying, Colby, you chopped up. I'm gonna lock this frame down. Colby should pop the yellow over the hole here, in my opinion.
Yeah, it's not a bad shot, really.
It just takes away the comfort ball and the control that Renata will feel she has at the moment over the frame. And meanwhile, it's probably a decent chance we're going to have another tactical frame with Mick and Joel.
There's been a few already.
This is a pretty good shot from Joel, I think. It's just fallen a touch short. If he only got that ball on the side rail, that would have been a super shot. Actually, I can see Mick. I can see Mick Hill having a dip here and having a crack at the clearance.
Well, I think it's really good to see this side of Mick Hill's game too, like being involved in a few actual games of pool. Because I dare say he has a lot of talent in that area as well.
Oh, he does. He knows his B game's good. Since you don't see it that often. I'm not sure what Colby did, but I think maybe... Did Renato just foul then? By not hitting a cushion? I didn't actually see the full outcome.
No, I didn't see it.
How old is Rusty, I've been asked. I actually don't know, but looking at his head, I'm going to say he's about 92 years old.
Well,
no, I don't know. He'd probably be, at a guess, maybe his mid-30s.
What year was it when that $100,000 tournament was on that Peter Wirth put on?
Oh, that was a long time ago.
I think that was 2000 and he would have been 19 then. So what's that, mate? 35.
Okay, well, there you go, mid-30s.
Yeah, he came down and won the novice.
There will definitely be family of Rusty watching, or some relations or friends. Someone just send us a message and tell us how old Rusty is, just for the sake of it. See how many years he's got left of him on the eight ball scene. Everybody's got an expiry date in whatever sport they choose. My expiry date occurred when I was 4. I didn't even get out of the gates, Pikey.
So, we got another big battle here, Mick Hill and Joel. Colby with the long red, Jamie. Oh, just jawed it. Just jawed it.
Oh, I was not bad off the mark. I just got Vanessa Smiley just sent me the answer. Rusty's 38.
38. There you go.
And shout out to Vanessa as well. I'm actually a bit disappointed you and Brent haven't turned up this year. You should make an effort next year. And you guys have seen the talent that's here. And I know Reedy's still crazy mad about the game of pool. He's doing himself an injustice by not playing here in this competition and competing.
Yes. Five, two.
Who's up?
Jake and Rusty.
Who's winning, Jake or Rusty? Rusty's 5-2 up. That's not what I was expecting the scoreline to be at that point in the match. But I can't say what's happened there. It's all going to come down to who's missing and who's not and who's taking chances, like it always does at the top level.
There you go, Joel spotted Mix Yellow again.
I just got a message from Vanessa. I think the reason that they didn't come to Big Gus stole all their money, she said. That's a classic response.
Yeah, Gus isn't here either.
I'm actually not sure who Gus got eliminated by. I know we lost... What was it, 11-10 on the live stream, or 11-9 from one of the English fellas? My memory's so crap with names lately. I can't remember who it is. I just called him the...
The English fella.
No. It was two short names. And he looks... Everyone reckons he looked a bit like Jake, but bigger.
Bigger?
Well, he's a big unit. Big unit, the fella.
Oh, what a nice shot.
He's a, he'd be about 6 foot four or something, fella.
That was a nice shot from Mick there. I think he's only got the one.
So Renata's about to go 3-1 up as well. A few danger signs for Colby. She needs to...
Yeah, she missed the long red before.
Yeah, she's got to make these clearances if she's going to commit aggressively.
So Joel in a spot of bother in this battle.
Dave Ewing knocked Gus out. Dave was just here a minute ago, he's gone. Now people would have seen the way Mick played last night against Robbo and basically just didn't miss a ball in the whole, he maybe missed two or three balls for the whole match.
That was a great shot by Joel.
And then I've had some questions saying that Mick's playing totally different to the way he did last night. Well, yeah, he has to, because the ball's just not falling in such a way where he can pot out every time.
And also the players playing differently against him. Sometimes when a player goes into that battle mode, you don't have any choice but to join him, you know what I mean?
That's right.
When he shuts you down, you can't just go and pot all the balls.
Well, we might get you an update too for Lyndall Morfitt and Lauren Jelly. The score is 2-1 to Lauren Jelly at the moment. Actually, make that 3-1. Lyndall's just missed a pretty difficult ball along the rail.
Shot from Joel here. He's cut the red in. He's landed behind the two reds. That was a big shot from Joel, but he's ended up a bit straight. He would have liked a little bit of angle on this back cushion ball.
Send me the link to the stream in Facebook, can you? Facebook Messenger.
So,
we've been blessed, Pikey.
Mm-hmm.
Joining us in the booth right behind me is Melissa Crawley, one of the tournament organisers. We might have to get her in for an interview later. Yesterday she wasn't up for it. She had a few sherbets. The day before then. She's a Logie, she's doing the red carpet business. Tournament organiser, red carpet walker. She does it all. And might add, she has pumped a fair bit of money into the ladies' big guns as well to make the prize pool what it is. So that's a very generous contribution.
Mm-hmm. So Mick landed behind his bad ball here.
How's his angle, Pikey? Do you reckon he's going a bit close to the top corner pocket?
Yeah, the other problem is he's a little bit near the rail too, so it's not as easy to control as he'd probably like.
He could fall short of it. Oh, yeah, it was fine. It looked dodgy, but it was actually fine.
Can he just drop this in and hold for the black in the middle?
Yeah, he'll actually kill the white completely dead with drag.
This is one of those ones where if you roll it, you've got to trust the table. And you get a slight roll off and you can jaw the ball.
Or you can hit it too thin and run high. Mm. He's gonna kill the hell out of this white with drag. Oh wow. Okay, that is the last shot I expect him to play, and that was, in my eyes, that is a suicide shot.
Well, maybe he couldn't hold, I don't know.
I don't know, man. Even if he'd come half table, he still would have been happy with a cut in the middle, surely. But this double is just screaming, show me I'm the world number one.
Is it even on, though, Jamie?
I reckon it is. I reckon it's on. I reckon it flies in, but obviously you've got to hit it right. But I don't reckon the red's in the way, if that's what you're sort of talking about. He hasn't got two, has he?
No.
See, he's overcut it. It was on
easy.
Come
on, Joel. Come on, mate.
So, Joel, huge chance to go 2-1. And realistically, probably should be 2-1 up himself. What is going on here with Mick Hill?
Yeah, it's definitely...
I'm really surprised he didn't drag the hell out of that ball. Meanwhile, Colby has a yellow off the red in the middle. She's got a dodgy yellow on the right side of the table as well, but that also goes off the red in the middle. So,
or after she moves this red, it doubles as well. Joel's missed.
Wow. I'll tell you what, small consolation prizes left the Chinese snooker.
Mate, these shots are not easy.
No, they're not. That's what I'm saying. It's a consolation. If you had good queuing at this, this is already over this frame. But the Chinese snooker over that distance does make this very missable. Geez, I'll tell you, he looks to be queuing nicely at it too with that bridge.
He does. He has a solid bridge.
Okay. Oh, is he? It's just like taking a Sunday stroll. Got it pretty easy. Oh, yeah. Colby.
He makes that look easy, but I mean...
It was a tough shot. You've got to get through the ball perfectly. Otherwise, you just swerve it.
The fundamentals there, you've got to have a solid bridge. You don't want any movement in your bridge hand. I remember talking to Brett Rogers, who knows a little bit about the game and queuing, and I was telling him about having a sloppy bridge hand. Got my hand on the table, and he starts smashing it with his fist. He goes, "It shouldn't move when I smash it." Meanwhile, my hand swelled up to about three times the size, but... But that's how solid you need to be with your bridge. No movement. That's the ideal.
Score updates, folks. Rusty Wheeler is 6-2 up now on Jake. Obviously, you can see the scores on your screen with these two matches, and Lauren is still 3-1 up on Lyndall Morfitt.
Ugh.
Once again, Pikey, these balls, they're not breaking open like we saw last night.
No.
Heaps of clusters and awkwardness and balls covering one another, and there's no free-flowing options at the moment.
I think Joel will be happy with that kind of pull.
Oh, it absolutely stood him down the ground just to keep Mick, number one, in his chair a bit longer each shot, and number two, just keeps him alive because Mick makes so many clearances. I mean, he's not the world number one for no reason.
No.
That's not a good miss there from Joel, but he's got a... Well, Mick actually has the red in the middle. But once again, they're all just dodgy.
Rusty chance here could be going 7-2, I think.
Yeah, Rusty's destroying Jake at the moment.
Looks like the black squeezes inside the yellow too. So Rusty. Oh, he's wiped its feet, but wow. It's gone in. Rusty 7-2 up.
Here's this red in the middle I just spoke about. Dealt with, but so much more to deal with. You've got these three balls near the side, right side rail. Just not pleasant by any means. But you may see some extraction occur here. Mick's going to putt. I'm assuming he's going to be looking at pumping this red, bottom corner, coming off bottom side and in behind the reds, try and get a dismount on.
Probably the first red.
I think the first one of them too, yeah. So not the one on the cushion, but the two that are closest to one another. Oh, he's caught the black, but wow, that's still a good result.
Especially if he's onto the one in the corner and move the black a bit. If the black might even be on across that way though.
Yeah,
too.
I reckon it is. But he's going to have to eliminate this ball at the bottom end of the table as quickly as possible as well. You know what? You need to free up the path for the other one.
In saying that, he also doesn't want those two up in balk to be his last two, because getting back for the black won't.
I'm going to give a quick shout out to the Punt Hub boys.
The who hub?
The Punt Hub. I just shared a few select boys a link. A couple of them I think just whacked on the stream and have a quick look.
So there's something Mick Hill laid up there. He could have had a go, but he realised they were, you know, not ideal.
Well, they're dodgy as hell, and that's why. That's what I'm saying. He's still got the B game, and he's actually. I don't reckon he's playing amazing right now. I know he's 3-1 up, but he should be 2-all. You know, Joel's missed that previous opportunity.
That's the thing with this game, Jamie. You often don't get the chances. So when you do get the chances, you've got to take them.
Did you just see that?
Yep.
I cannot believe how simple that ball was in comparison. He's missed again. And this is actually, I shouldn't say good to see, because you don't want to see anyone actually missing. But it just shows that even Mick Hill is a rhythm, like needs a little bit of rhythm to, you know, to flow and make those consistent pot outs.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, it's...
The one thing that he's not doing, though, and you rarely ever see him do, is miss a ball that guarantees loss of frame. Mm. Like, even though he's missed that, Joel's balls are still very tricky and he needs to manufacture an out.
But it shows, too, that, you know, even the best, if they get sort of tied up and off their rhythm, like you say, their natural pace, it's very easy when you're flowing to keep potting balls and play well, but to come out of a battle and then turn on.
That's really hard. I don't know how many times I've played a really long tactical frame and someone have got the out and I just missed some easy black. Because you're just not queuing well. Because you're so busy in tactical mode. It's really hard to readapt. That's a good shot. I don't think... Yeah, Dan's just mentioned he hasn't got a lot of crowd support. In fact, if anything, they're hostile as hell. Because, well, one, he's come from foreign soil, he's taken our money. And two, everybody loves an underdog. Play for the cannon here. This is dangerous to go in off the middle. Oh, no, he's not doing it.
He's laid up as well.
I thought he was going to try for the cannon there, but it was risky. If you catch any top side of one of those balls, you're straight in off. Somehow Colby's got back to the table.
She's got a little bit too much angle here, but she can come around the black. It's no problem.
You think she'll just soft screw this and play for the left centre?
Yeah.
Or go around the angles, Rusty Wheeler style.
You can just drop it in and play for the black in the middle, you're right.
I don't think you can't play it plain ball, can you? It's pretty close to enough.
No, I think it's hard to see, but I think she's missing the enough. She is dipping into it.
Oh, Colby.
Oh, she's got the second prize, I think.
Nah, she's left her on it. She's just not feeling it at the moment. Well,
have a look.
I can't now. Nah, she can pot it. Oh wow. Oh, speaking of second prizes, here's your second prize, Pike. Look at this. No, I think she's left her on it as well.
Yeah, she's just on.
Well, that's a gift. That's very, very fortunate. I'll tell you what, if Colby can pinch his frame back.
Rusty, 8-2.
Yeah, that match is well and truly done over there, folks. Absolutely finished. I've actually not seen Jake come back against someone like Rusty from that deficit before. He doesn't do it. That's one thing he probably needs to improve. Excellent shot from Colby there, and this black is going straight in.
It's very hard to beat Rusty when he's flying with his tail up.
Yeah, it is. He's one of the best front runners in the game. So Colby looks really angry with himself, probably more than anything, and should be buzzing though to pinch that frame back.
So Mick Hill plays the combo. Beautiful control there. I think this red sneaks inside the yellow.
I'll tell you what I can sense happening, Pikey, if Mick wins this frame. I can sense a shift occurring.
Man.
I reckon the balls will start to open up and we'll start seeing some outs. And I reckon he's going to start to accelerate. I can just sense it.
Yeah, well.
See how he's starting to speed up a bit as well.
Yeah, I found that shot interesting because he could have screwed back half that distance and played it in the middle, but he elected to screw past it and play for the open pocket. But
do you have two shots, did he? Oh, there you go.
Ah, that's why. Okay. Yeah, he did have the two visits still.
Lauren Jelly is now 3-2 up on Lindell Moore for his peg one back. Lauren Jelly, you can see her there wearing a Queensland shirt. Pretty much the only t-shirt I've ever really seen her wear, because every time I see her, she's at Nationals.
Yeah. Yeah, she's been playing for a long time, hasn't she?
Yep. Yeah, like I said, I think she kind of disappeared off the scene there for a year or two. I don't believe she's played Nationals, has she, lately? But then again, I could be full of it because I haven't been going myself. So maybe she has been, I just ignore. Big break there from Joel, and must capitalise on this opportunity. And my first prediction's come true, Pikey. The balls have opened up.
Yeah. Hardest pot here probably is the black.
Yeah, you just got to make sure you transition back to it.
What's your last ball for the black here, Jamie?
Come on. I think it's going to be one of these, the one he's eyeing off now. That was sort of initially the one I thought, but then I thought to myself, no, it's actually going to be the other one that's just below it. But he might be too straight. If he can actually screw across the right side rail, pick the gap between the yellow and the red, he's in a really good spot then to knock all these three bottom balls off and then just head back up for that one in the middle. Yeah, that's perfect. Ooh, has he come too high, too low? No, he's okay.
Yeah, I think he's got the combination anyway if he's not on it.
Pretty sure he's on the top one, and he can just, as long as he comes off the rail.
Yeah, he's on it. He's on it.
Colby's brought back about 54 bottles of water. She must be thirsty as hell.
So,
he's just got a touch trickier, I reckon.
Yeah, I mean, getting out from that bottom red to get onto that middle red, to get onto the black, it's not straightforward, is it?
It's not now.
You know, you got to get the right angle two or three times in a row.
See what he does. I think he can stun this, actually, but he's not gonna.
He's hitting it high.
This is actually got to be hit well.
He might even play for the long red here.
I reckon that's a shot, Bikey. Just don't risk yourself to miss, but he's looking at somehow getting over. Oh, he must be straight. The camera angle is
screw,
just deceiving.
Screw past the yellow.
Screw off the side rail, yeah. Just give himself a shot where he's got angle to just float off the table. That's perfect. That's a great shot. You actually can't hit that any better.
Do you come in behind the black or do you play for the middle?
Play for the middle.
Middle, yeah.
He pretty much is playing his plain ball and just get the pace right. He might come off the back rail, but yeah, that's good. Don't expect Joel to miss this, even though his queuing's a little hampered. Should be okay. And this is the crowd.
Come on.
Suddenly the crowd goes nuts. It's been silent as a pin drop. You can hear a pin drop in here, rather, and suddenly, bang. No surprises, Sahil Sharma is the loudest bloke there. And then we've heard the old, come on the bums.
Yeah.
It's like, someone from England coming to here and yelling out, come on the Poms, is like one of the Australians going over and when the World Cup is on and England's playing Germany and going, come on Germany. After they've already lost.
So Mick's screwed all the way back there off that break. Screwed straight back to the top cushion.
And look, open balls.
Changed his break a bit.
Yeah, and they've opened up and he's going to pot out. I've already called it.
He is going to put it out on the Reds.
It's 5-2. Re-rack them.
Do you like the Reds? I like the Reds.
I like the Reds. Just re-rack the balls and start again. 5-2.
You pretty much run down the table in order.
I'm doing my best to mozzie him, aren't I? 5-2. Let's go.
You might see him get rid of the bottom red before the one near the middle pocket. Use that one near the middle pocket as his last red. Either way is fine, I think.
Look at him speed up his pace too. You see what I'm saying? Like his tempo's picked up. He wants this match to shift gears right now. He's going to stun across. That's right. Because I'm pretty sure that black, it flies in the corner. I don't think the yellow's in the way at all. It's just a camera angle.
Oh, yeah. They look close together, don't they?
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure it flies in.
30 seconds to hold out.
There's only one person.
Ooh.
I thought that was dodgy, but it's fine. There's only one person in the room that pots out quicker than that, and that's Ben Noonan. Where are you? I don't think he's ever watched a live stream in his life. Once Ben Noonan's out, he leaves, gets drunk, doesn't want anything to do with pool ever again. Until the next tournament.
Come on, Joel.
Come on, Joel.
Colby has a lot of pocket control on his frame. Oh. Every time we flick to where she's missing, we might have to not go full screen at all on Colby, Dan. Every time we've done it so far, she's missed.
So, Lauren Jelly 4-2 up on Lindell.
So Lauren has got her two-frame gap back. Rusty 9-2.
9-2. Can Jake fire up?
Geez, that's a lot of firing to do. It's a lot of breaks Rusty gets to not run racks. It's it's looking ominous for the big head. But I have to give him credit. He's made the last four with the worst preparation that he's ever put in for a pool comp of this magnitude.
Come on, Jakey.
It just shows how good the bloke is.
Tell you what, he's got a nice spread there. Jake's got a chance to get one back anyway.
I think Joel can sneak through to this ball on the right side rail. And if he can, and punch it in, because it is a shot you do have to punch in for the optimal position.
Yeah.
Just rolling this in, I'm not sure that it's ideal, although I guess you've got the cut. You don't want to catch the other red. So I really believe you need to back your ability and punch this in.
You're probably right.
If you're going to win the match, this shot needs to be makeable and get the white where you want it.
And it might be the kind of shot that gets you going too. You make the out here.
That's a great shot.
Well controlled.
So now, one would think that he's going to come up to the middle pocket off the side cushion after this shot.
That would make sense. Just hit the side cushion a little bit before the middle pocket. Maybe a little bit sort of flick of right-hand side and just below centre.
Yeah, I reckon you're spot on there, mate. Oh, he checked it.
No, he just... I tell you what, I might take the bottom left one first.
Yeah, absolutely. Now you just run through this and get a natural angle to just come off side rail through the giant gap between black and the three yellows. And as long as you land anywhere sort of where you are right now with the white, you can come off two rails. You've got two shots, haven't you? You've got two shots. He's got one. But he's going to back himself to pot this black. I saw a foul on the other table and I was for some reason thinking it was here.
That's a nice angle.
You will need a bit of side. Just a little bit.
Just got to run through. Just make sure you don't run into those three yellows.
And if Joel does make this clearance, it is an excellent response to Mick to say, yes, mate, yeah, good on you for potting out in 14 seconds. I may have taken a minute and 80, which is really 2 minutes and 20.
My random numbers didn't work. Help me out there.
But it's a response. And Joel just needs to make one good solid pot here. It doesn't even have to move the wire as long as it doesn't go forward. Great shot. And Joel will not miss this ball with an action like his. And we are about to go 5-3. Good response from Joel Younger.
Yes, well, he's hanging in there.
Yeah. He actually has no idea who he's playing anymore, if that makes sense. Mm. He is playing the balls. His opponent is now irrelevant, if it was relevant earlier.
I think he'll be, you know, not happy with... He's had a few chances that went astray early, but...
That's what I mean. Early on, probably a little bit nervous. Mm. And, you know... Regardless of what you say, Mick Hill's got factor on players, regardless of their level. And it's like you think about the person that, you know, look at your own level and then think about the person that always beats you and how they've got so much factor over you. Well, that's what Mick Hill does to these other players. But now the factor for Joel's gone. He doesn't even know who he's playing now. He's at a comfort point in this match where he can just play the balls. And that is very important to get into as early as possible. That's a good shot from Renata. She's managed to clear the yellow and get on a very nice black. She's about to go 4-2 up on Colby Poole.
Sometimes
she rolls that, Jesus.
Sometimes in matches like this too, Jamie, it can be when both players are off to a bit of a shaky start, it can sort of be who settles first, you know, finds their feet. And
yeah, for sure. And what often you'll see happens if one does settle first, the scoreline, well, it probably comes beside what Jake and Rusty is. It's 9-3 over there now, so Jake's pegged one back. Nice shot there from Giles. Flicked the black out. He's got a linking ball in the middle. And another excellent opportunity to win this frame.
All of a sudden, 5-4.
Wouldn't we like to see it? Did Mick try a break? We don't see that very often either. He hasn't got the break going today like he did last night. Robbo's probably sitting at home right now punching his TV going, why didn't you dry break on me last night, you muppet?
Yeah. It's always hard when you get knocked out of a tournament and you watch the next black and the next match and the bloke gets 1,000 chances where you got none. And
and it doesn't matter who you are. It is a certainty to happen every time. Every time I get knocked out of a tournament, I half not want to know what's happened, because I go and watch the person who just beat me. There's an absolute dollar for he's missed about 45 pots. Good example. Samoa Naka knocked me out of his tournament and then gets wrecked by Rusty 8-1. Samoa, you imbecile.
Rusty can wreck people 8-1 pretty easy.
Probably
too.
Probably would have wrecked me 8-1 as well.
Come on, Joel!
I think that's okay. You know he's going to play the one closest to the pocket on the left-hand side.
It'll be... Rusty 9-3 up over there. We'll be... good to see the big man in the final.
Well,
he puts on a show.
He does, and like I said, he gives himself a nickname, but I've decided to go with it and call him that nickname. That's Big Daddy Freestyle. Jeez, John's queuing great now.
Yeah, he's number one fan, Nick Howe. He loves to call him Big Daddy.
Yeah. Where was he this year for Big Guns? We needed a bit of wizardry in the draw. Jeez, I'll tell you what, he
a little straight
with that. You know, I got a question. If he wasn't happy with it, like how he was going to land, why not just play the other one first?
But maybe it was just a little bit of, you know, not lack of care, but not full concentration on that second last shot.
You also eliminate this yellow out of play for play the other one first. He's all right.
He had to force that with a bit of side, but he got there.
He's made it look easy.
Yeah, probably pinched the pocket a little.
This is 5-4, and Mick's now. Mick, John has a break too. And for the very, this is the first time for this tournament that Mick Hill has actually been challenged in such a way where the score line shows it, because Robbo did challenge him last night, it's just Robbo didn't get an opportunity because there was too many racks run on him.
It's also probably the first time where Mick Hill's appeared a little human. He's made some blunders.
Yeah, he's missed some easy balls. And Joel's run two racks in a row. Three in a row. Can Joel continue this run? There's a long, long way to go before we reach the end of this match. Needs a ball. He's got one.
He's got two.
Oh, what do you take here, Pikey? This is dodgy street. This is tricky as hell.
You reckon?
Well, what do you like? You like yellows, obviously.
I like yellows.
Tell me how you pot out on them, though, this visit, if you're going to go.
I'm taking the middle ball and getting up on the one in balk first shot.
Do you know what I'm doing? Never mind. I'm thinking you can just promote this yellow and leave no shot, but you probably leave one on the side rail.
See, I would have got right up on the balk one off the first shot.
I don't know if he had the angle, though. Like, he screwed back pretty much straight.
He had the
there.
Two different balls. He had two options to get up there.
And the other one might have had more angle than he would have liked.
See, the problem now is, with that cushion ball, he's got to get down table a little bit further than he would have had to before.
It's not just that. This yellow that's near the black is a nightmare.
There's room to get behind that.
It's still a nightmare. That's a good shot. Good recovery shot. See where he's lining up now. He's lining up very straight. Wants to get straight to run through and get behind that shot you were just talking about, Pikey. Yeah. But even then, this yellow that's on the right hand side of the table, the red, that's still a little tricky as well. It's not straightforward.
It's definitely.
It only goes in the left middle. Oh, and obviously the bottom right corner, but to transition the bottom right corner is unlikely.
He was looking at the gap between the two reds there. I'm not sure off this shot or the next shot.
That angle's too great to get on this left-hand side ball now. Do you attack this plant? Do you attack this plant or not?
On this shot or on the next
shot? On this shot. To me, the angle looks like it's coming from back rail and it's going to cannon the red on the left-hand side. Now, I reckon this yellow that's just below the black goes in the right middle. Joel says, shut up, playing this shot.
Yeah. That's not bad. He's opened that pocket up for the yellow as well. Is he on the corner ball, though?
Yeah, that's a strange choice of shot. Like, it doesn't do anything to help him put out here.
Can he? He's got those two reds over near the side cushion with that yellow there. Can he play the yellow near the black now, off the red, and get it over this other corner?
The red off the rail?
Yeah, play it off this red and try and sit it in over the pocket.
You don't want to risk. Yeah, you probably have to, you're right. Oh, wow.
He's played
to. Oh, that's actually a very clever shot. He's got a good result, but that's a clever shot.
Nice white ball, too. He hadn't left much.
Excellent shot there from Joel Young. And he is taking it to Mick Hill, and I'm loving it.
That was a good shot.
It's well thought out. Sometimes when you're presented with a situation like this where you can't really do anything, your best option is to smash three balls and try and get a result.
Well, I don't know about that. I mean, if
you've played for the plant in the top left-hand corner.
You're kidding. He's not going to play your shot, is he?
No, he's playing. For, he's actually playing for the plant.
Oh, that is sick.
I called it.
That is sick.
I called it, but it was sick. I saw him lining it up, and then I realised what he was up to.
As Scotty Matthews would call that, the swoosh shot. The advanced swoosh shot.
We're gonna have to remove Ecky from the stool near the camera. He keeps shaking it.
Yeah, we need a barrier around that camera. Oh,
that misses.
How tight are these down the cushion?
Oh, these pockets are bubbers.
He's lucky the red didn't draw out of the way there.
Yeah, Joel's going to have to pop the ball in the middle and play a double on the yellow, I think. Look at this shot.
Oh, that is sick.
Actually, it's pretty crap. He didn't even pop the other yellow red. Poor shot. I'm just kidding, folks. I think his angle he's going to have off this might be nice, too. Yep. Just got to be a little careful with the white here. Because it is heading up sort of towards the black ball. The angle he's got to hit this yellow at.
Yeah, you don't want to snooker yourself either.
And realistically, you must make this out because even if you don't get this ball, that red that's sort of the trickiest in three that is just below the white now, it's Mick's going to land on it. Oh, he was straight enough to hold.
Yes! Tell you what, there's a bit of crowd support for the job.
Oh, you think? Like I said, it wouldn't have mattered what person right now was playing against Mick. The same crowd would have been screaming right there. And it'll be the same thing next match that he plays, whether it be tomorrow, today, whatever.
Yeah,
great. Jeez, he played that well. Righto, Joel. The whole room is wheeling this one in to go 5-all.
I reckon he took an extra feather there.
And what a comeback from Joel. And if Mick didn't think he had a hostile crowd, he certainly knows it now.
I think there's even drums going in the background, yeah. Jamie.
I'll tell you what, we might see just an extra couple of Ks in the brake pair on this shot. He may take the risk to dump the white for the extra power for the big split and run. He wants to run this rack. He wants to say, listen, guys, shut up. Here we go.
See what he does, whether he screws back or stuns. He's played the stun break that time.
He's actually trying different things. He's normally dead centre on the table.
Yeah, he's moved the white around a bit on the break.
He's having trouble with the break.
He did that last year too, I noticed, that he wasn't getting balls and then he moved over to the side and started getting balls. Every table plays different off the break too.
But the funniest thing is, this is the table he played rubber on last night. Oh, hang on. What was it? No, it wasn't. It was the one that Colby and Renato were playing on. Which is a much better table, in my opinion.
So, Joel, he's got the wings out.
Rusty's on the hill, 10-4 on McCartney.
10-4 on the confirmation.
Finally, Pikey, you've been around and we've finally got a big 10-4 on the confirmation. Debbie, are you at home watching this stream? We've got a big 10-4. No one has a bloody clue what I'm talking about.
No, except for the truckies.
No, it goes back. Might as well tell the story while there's a bit of clusterage. I don't know how many years ago at Berry tournament. I think I couldn't qualify, so I decided I'm going to have a drink instead. And it was me, Travis Henderson, and Travis Matthews. All getting pretty loud and happy because we're all in the same boat. And I didn't really know Debbie back then very well, and I don't even know why I said, can I get a big 10 from a confirmation? But there is a scene in the American Pie movie where
the guy is basically about to see two girls get it on, and he's on the walkie-talkie saying stand by for confirmation. And the truckie gets on the CB and goes, that's a big 10-4 in the confirmation. And yeah, I just ran with it, and I said it to Debbie as she was walking out the door, and she hated my guts for it. But I think she's all right now. Oh, look at this shot from Colby Pool. Great shot from Colby there. But I'm not sure she, not sure you can, unless she's got two, I'm not sure you can commit to this out. No, she's got the angle to get into these and actually be able to develop the red though. It's a big ask. Meanwhile.
I think it's fair to say, Jamie, this frame is probably a pretty important frame in the context of the match.
The 5-all one or the 4-2
yeah,
one?
Yeah, the 5-all, sorry, for Mick and Joel. It's, Joel's on a run.
Yeah, Colby's tried to develop that red, and that was pretty much about the result I expected her to get. It was a big ask. But look, I'm not going to hold it against her that she's attacking the game.
She's just got the one visit?
Well, she might have two. This is why I'm saying I wasn't sure. But
yeah,
even if she's only got one, I understand why she's doing it. I think I've got to say though, if she does happen to go 5-2 down in this match, it might be a good time for her to start going, you know what, some percentage plays that have probably come into play here.
Even Brett's just texted in, he's agreed that Joel's odds have come in. He's shortened now.
What's he now? What is he now? He's 590,000 to 1. Not bad. Not bad. I'll tell you, Brett, I'll have a dollar on it.
Dollar.
And you know if Mick loses this match, Brett's going to message me asking me for the dollar.
It's good to see you. Good to see Mick under a little bit of a challenge. We'll see how he performs, what he comes up with.
Yeah, absolutely. And I expected a bit of an open match and a bit of a shift of gears happening. The only thing is, the shift of gears happened for Joel, not for Mick, and then suddenly we've got a tight frame again.
So, interesting shot.
Very interesting shot. Well, I think he's actually tried to cover the middle pocket there, like keep the red from being able to go in it, and that way it makes those two reds extremely awkward.
The biggest thing about that shot, he was trying to leave Joel only the option on the red over the corner, you know what I mean? These white balls.
He's just going to bump it though. You can see Mick running up behind this red, can't you?
Well, yeah, I think problem is you try and go up table, you're leaving Joel options then, aren't you?
Oh, look at the result Colby's just got. That's massive.
Did she hit the red? Yep.
Yeah, but her white ball's sick. Although, right now, that's probably going to be able to just play a little drop snooker, but there she has. Isn't it amazing how well the girls can play those little touch shots? I used to be good at them, now I suck.
How is the touch on that? I think it hit the cushion. Mix clipped the edge of the yellow, pushed the red to the side cushion, left the white heart up on the bottom cushion. And I'm pretty sure he made the distance. I don't think it was a foul.
It's a good shot. Jeez, I tell you what, Colby's coming close to fouling here. She's had 20 seconds.
Oh, the 20-20.
At least 10 seconds to go. And she's fouled. And look at that, she's actually played it terribly.
Yeah, because she was rushed by the clock.
She should have just elevated the cue massively in the air and just let the tip touch the cue. I think the clock's actually sort of rattling her a bit, although she has played under it before. But who knows what's going through her head, only she does. Well, Joel is dealing with a riddle that is reds. Oh, Renata's just missed a really bad shot. And tell you what, Colby's sort of semi-reliant on some strawberries at the moment.
Oh, Joel's.
Oh, he's missed. That's what he's done. Although, it's not the worst miss of the world.
He had the angle there to open up the yellow and black as well.
Absolutely. And it was all going to be about transitioning to that really difficult red at the top of the table.
Does that red go up past the yellow?
It doesn't look like it does on the camera, but... Is that red on?
Yeah.
The red past the yellow. It is on. Oh, wow, that's a bad miss for Joel there. So that red does go pikey, so that's actually a bad miss because that was another frame-winning opportunity.
What's Mick going to play for here? A double on the yellow near the black, or...?
I've got the ideal angle to do it now, has he?
No, but he can get in behind the two yellows here. Stun off the top cush or come round behind them.
I reckon Renato's going to cannon the yellow here.
He's played to come round behind them.
Well, even worse, he's not landed on it.
A little bit of awkward queuing.
Yeah, but how do you transition? Even if you can pot the yellow and pot the other one, how do you transition, Pikey?
Yeah, that's... he may go off the side cush and pot it into the opposite middle, like hit it from behind. Not this yellow, the other yellow, no.
Surely you can't have a dip here, like, I don't... What? Well, he knows what he's doing.
He's playing it with a lot of left-hand side.
Missed it. Oh, I understand.
Come on, Joel, come on,
he's gone for the... He's actually played to...
Pot it inside the
air, and then he'd run through and then play the double.
So Joel with a chance here. You've got to... You've nearly got to take this opportunity, don't you? You have to. Well, you know, you can't keep giving away chances.
Now this is big, this shot coming up. That looks good.
He's played it.
Yes, mate, come on.
Now, Pikey, do you think this ball in the bottom right-hand corner, you can play it to just go into the black? You only have to tickle it.
You only need a nudge. I think the one closest to the yellow and the black is ideal for the nudge. So I would...
Free shot at it now then, what do you reckon?
Yeah.
I think it's a shot. He's
yes,
got it.
Mate, come on.
And the glory about playing it there, it was pretty much impossible to not be on the red as long as you got a fairly full contact.
Any contact there and he's on that red, but now he's just going to float up the table, Jamie?
Float up, yes. Absolutely. We need to do a bit of floating. I haven't done float for at least 14 minutes. And Joel is about to take the lead here.
He's coming a little bit short on that.
He's perfect, Pikey. He's just going to stun back for the opposite pocket.
The angle looks like he's...
The angle is perfect. I'm telling you, he's right, absolutely spot right. on. Look at this. Hello. Oh, okay. Wouldn't have liked to be on the rail. You were right, Pike. You did have
this
my
was just a fraction way. Short. It was a fraction short, was that? Should still get this.
Look at this shot from Colby. Oh, big effort. Yes!
And Joel Younger has hit the lead.
And this is the first time that Mick Hill has trailed at the big guns this year. I'm not sure if when Woodsy was playing, whether he trailed or not.
Come on, Joel! Fire up!
Oh, Renato's quite a shocker.
Okay.
And Barry Crocker?
Yeah, he's giving Colby a chance.
Joel Younger with the break.
This is getting interesting, this match.
Tell you what.
I've been crapping on all weekend how Mick Hill cannot lose his tournament. What a shot from Colby. She's got the little mini result too. She's got a shot on this black. Oh yeah, I've been crapping on all tournament how you can't win this tournament, and I'm starting to believe I need to eat my words.
Well, it's only early days yet.
It is early days still, but I tell you, I'm starting to believe.
A few people starting to get a bit excited though. And I reckon one of those blokes is Joel. He's probably just starting to get a little bit of belief, a little bit of fire there.
Yeah, as long as he doesn't get a bit of nerves as he gets close to the finish line.
He's pretty professional. He's been through all of, you know.
He is probably the most professional eight ball player we have in the country, as far as that, you know. Him and Ron, they're both extremely professional the way they conduct themselves. Hello, Reds. Actually, hang on, wait a minute. Hello, Yellows. Have a look at Yellows.
Mellow Yellow?
Yeah, play the screw back the first one.
Red, red. Yellow, yellow. My personal opinion is probably Yellows, I would say, Jay.
Yeah, I changed my opinion really quickly. Dan's just pulling down. This is the first time the Mix had a 2020 timer in his tournament. It is.
Yeah. He's not a fan of the 2020.
I don't know if it's affected him, though.
No.
But it's an interesting thing to note. Colby's got another shot at shit. It's like, what is going on here? What a shot. And I'll tell you what, right now, she's 4-3 down. That could actually be the biggest turning point we'll have seen in this match by a mile.
I know Michael Skerry will be watching out there. He loves the turning point.
He will actually be screaming at turning point on that particular shot. That's a big shot for Colby. Don't knock that little Riley sense. He's still okay. In fact, this might be perfect, Mikey. Has he got an angle to just drop on this?
I think he can run behind the one near the back, yep.
This is starting to get sick.
Starting to get fair dinkum, Joe.
It is, it's starting to get real. For all you internationals, I don't even know if you know the Aussie lingo, fair dinkum. And bloody oath, mate. Thanks to neighbours.
Oh, no.
That's not awesome.
That's not awesome.
He was so concerned in making sure he got down for it.
This is where he needs one of these thin Mikil well-controlled cuts and just stopping against the two reds.
Yeah, you're right. You're a little soft screw here and just not do a lot of movement with the white, but hit the pot.
Come on. This is the exact shot that Mickey Hill played earlier, you know, with such control. Just the pace of the ball and the pace of the shot.
Actually, is he on the ball in the middle? He played it well. He's missed the pot. Now it's in.
I tell you what.
How's this yellow? This yellow in the middle looks thin.
No,
but he's got hand for queuing pipe. It looks just a bit dodgy. You have to play the one in the corner first.
The one in the corner and then the one in the middle.
He's got hand for queuing on both, but I think the queuing is better on the one at the bottom of the table.
I think the one in the middle is fine, though, Jamie. Really, it's...
Actually, this is fine.
There's no problem.
Side rail, he's good here. Oh, he lifted the queue a little bit.
He didn't. There's a touch of whips are cracking.
Should be okay here though. Just drop this in. He's gonna score out of touch, I think. No, he's just dragging it. I don't expect Joel to miss this no matter the pressure.
Keep his nerves together.
No, he's good under the pump.
Literally a black off the spot, Jamie.
Pretty much, yeah. Well, even Joel, see that? Shows a bit of emotion. A little bit of a come on.
Leighton Hewitt.
Yeah, he didn't do the whole, you know, fingers in the forehead business, but... This match is getting really interesting. And you know what? Rusty has just won the match against Jake McCartney. What was the score? 10?
11.
11, sorry. 11-5. So Jake did get a couple back, but too little too late, unfortunately.
So, Big Daddy is ready for the big show.
Do you know what's actually funny about this match at the moment, last couple of frames, is Mick hasn't actually been able to do much about this.
No, Joel's, Joel's took the chances when he's had them. Jarrod break.
So he's got a tricky starter, though. He's going to want reds, and he's got a tricky starter the right middle.
Can he see through to the... No, I don't think he can. It's just.
I think he's going to take this ball in the middle. He's having a look at it.
Tell you what.
Come on, buddy. This is starting.
First
to be
shot's
huge.
A key here.
And if you had asked me out of the three players I thought could have beaten beaten Mick, my first answer would have been none of them. And then my second answer would have been Joel. Just because of his, I guess his nerve and his professionalism.
That's it.
And I don't think he's played Mick before either. But we're still a long way away, folks. He's still got to win four more frames. That's a lot of frames. And I don't know that this out's happening because that's a foul.
Colby's got two.
I can't really help with that. My goes.
Marker's double on the yellow.
I think run this yellow over the bottom right pocket and then maybe just get the other yellow out. Oh, he's gone too far. Or has he? No, he's okay,
it's
I think.
Right. It's all right.
Oh, he's pretty straight. He's pretty straight.
Maybe double the red now. Take it on.
I think the other yellow's in the way, isn't it? Oh, the other red.
Yeah. It's
hard
to see.
You see where he's lined up his cue now? He's basically full intentions is to play for a double. Oh, he hasn't come far enough. Actually, if he's come far enough where he can actually play the stun, because he'll be on that bottom ball. Swing back off the bottom rail out for the other one.
He's looking at the gap between the two yellows.
Yeah, I think that's what you've got to play for.
He's pretty much going to stun the white here.
To be honest, as long as you, when you play the double, it doesn't hit it, like if it doesn't go in, it doesn't hit the draw and die to the rail, you can actually go out still with the second visit. Oh, he's caught it. That's a great shot. I think he's on this.
Well, he's also got the outside red if he needs it, Jamie.
No, that's what I'm talking about. Play the outside red, come off the bottom cushion.
The combination.
Yeah, get just past the black spot, like just a little higher than it, so then you've just got the run in and then you land on your last
one. I think
one.
If he plays the combination, he's going to run into the yellows, though.
No, I'm talking about the ball over the hole.
Okay.
On the left-hand side, I reckon he's on it. And then he just comes off the bottom rail.
If he's on that, he'll touch a swerve. I think
he's just dragging it. Beautiful shot.
Okay.
And that angle is supreme.
Perfect.
Probably couldn't have put it better with your hand, and it's all about potting balls along the rail.
You want about a 45 degree angle on this red.
Do you want me to be completely honest with you, Poggy? Mm-hmm. I'd pot this and I'd promote that red and use my second visit. I'm not kidding you. Why risk it? He's got two shots.
The two.
Hang on, has he got two? No, he hasn't. No, he has. He's only got one.
Why
do I keep thinking he's got two all the time? Maybe I'm just dreaming.
Yeah, buddy, come on!
That's a good angle. Come on! Rest comes straight. Look how in the zone he is. Not even less than a second thought. Bang, rest straight out.
Well,
this is missable for sure. This is what I'm saying.
He's playing it with side, running around.
No, he can't be. He's screwing off for sure.
Yes! Yes!
Excellent shot from Joel Younger once again.
He's got the angle, he's alrighty.
Yeah, no, he'll pop this. This goes in. You know, he may actually just play with a touch around the side.
You don't want to do something stupid and go in off in the opposite middle.
Touch running side or just screw off it a little bit.
It's pretty thin on this black.
I reckon he's fine. I reckon he'll just stun off it a touch.
Do you have to play it with a bit of... Ooh.
I reckon they're natural enough close, Roy. You can just screw off it a little bit.
He might play it with a bit of check side.
Table up.
He might try and play it with a bit of check side.
I reckon check's
Jamie.
The only way he can miss this. I'd rather screw off this.
Yeah, but it's that thin that.
I don't reckon it's that thin, Pike. Have a look at the table. It's not that bad. See, look at that.
Yeah!
Great shot. Well controlled.
This is huge.
Well controlled.
Jack Phillips actually sent me a message earlier to remind me that Joel and Mick actually played a money match at Slate ages and ages ago, and the score was something like 13-12.
Yeah.
But there was some serious shenanigans going on that night with people crawling under the table and crap while Mick was playing and all sorts of business. So I said it didn't count. This certainly counts.
Oh, who's just sending you that message?
Oh, I can't say that.
Well, dude, that's a weak challenge, Mikey. You know I'm going to say that. So you can tell me who said it.
Well, I can't tell you who sent the message.
Someone sent Pikey a message saying that Joel's all over Mick like a fat lady eating cake. Like, I think I've said that comment like 30 times since I've been streaming.
But I tell you what, this is the best chance.
Oh, look at the yellows. Look at the yellows, Pikey.
I can see them.
It is
a roadmap, Jamie.
Can you say the word momentum? This is a crazy run of the ball. Mick cannot even pot a ball to save himself at the break at the moment.
Joel has about four different options for an ABC out here.
But here's the important part of this. You must keep this train rolling. The second that you miss the ball and derail, you allow your opponent back in, and that can swing the momentum entirely on this match. So Joel must basically keep the boots laying in.
He underhit that a little bit, but he's still got options. I think he's taken the middle one out of the triangle.
Yeah, I agree. The T shape.
He can't run up for the top one yet, though. He hasn't got the angle.
Might be able to just drop it in and play the one to the left.
No, he is on the other middle.
Oh, that's a bonus. Oh, and this is what I'm talking about, Mikey.
The derail?
The derail. I may have mozzed him.
You've called the derail.
I have called the potential derail, and you're not allowed to derail and allow. You're not allowed. Thomas was rolling. You can't let Percy on the track.
Yeah, it might be a touch of adrenaline there, maybe, Jamie.
I'll tell you what, if you've ever watched Thomas Tank Engine cartoons, Thomas is just all about Thomas. He doesn't care about anyone else. He just wants to please the fat controller. Also, top and back.
Oh,
now.
My goodness, Mick has drawn that shot.
Come on, Joel! Come on, man!
That black's still on.
Yeah, he's just trying to get himself going. Like, he's just smashed that. Hasn't cued it like he normally does. He's just smashed it.
Well, it just shows maybe he's feeling the pinch too.
It absolutely is. And it's really funny when you hear Mick commentate, he actually uses the words, or maybe not the exact words, but he basically talks about cueing the ball and bashing the ball,
yeah,
and the difference between it and the effect it has. And then he's actually just gone and displayed himself there, which obviously shows his humour. Great shot there from Colby Poole. Somehow she's going to go 4-4 in this match, and it feels like she should be like 5-1 down.
There you go.
Oh, no! Well, she's angry with herself. Filthy. I don't reckon this plant goes, though, Pikey.
No, not from that close.
I reckon she's still alright here.
I'm actually right behind this plant, Jamie.
No matter what happens in this frame, whether she wins it or not, she needs to take a toilet break. She needs to get her head right.
This plant is not on, but there is a bit of distance between the two reds, so.
Yeah, I don't think you can make them on, though.
Not from there.
Lauren Jelly's just missed a black as well, and I think she's about to go 5-5 now with Lindell.
She's filthy as well.
It's a tough game out there, though. That was not an easy pot she missed either. Ooh.
Joel.
Come on.
Tensed up a little again.
I reckon this out is gone. This could be the turning point for Mick Hill to. There's less balls now, you know what I mean, if Joel doesn't get this out.
This is the shot Rusty's good at. Pop this ball that's near the black spot with soft hands and deep screw to the back rail.
What happened there with Colby and Renata? Is Renata time foul?
I don't know, I
think the ball's moved.
Yes, Gold, come on!
Colby is just getting gift after gift from what I can see. She's obviously getting herself a chance, but then she's chopping up, and then suddenly she's just getting back to the table.
Joel's got the angle.
Shot from Joel.
He's got a good angle.
The only thing that can go wrong here, and you can see him checking it now, is he doesn't land on the bottom rail and slug himself behind the red.
Well, the angle that he's coming up, I think he's pretty much running into that red.
I reckon he's going slightly wide of it, just slightly.
Yeah, maybe.
If anything, cannoning the right hand side. But He hasn't got a massive area to land in, but it's good enough. As long as he'll land on the bottom roller in line with the red, he should be alright here. Why is he not low? He's playing ball, surely.
I think it just looks like he's hitting low.
He might be alright.
Yeah!
Oh, it's too far, is it? No, it's okay. It's perfect.
Too far. It's not far enough. It's too far. It's not far. It's...
He's kicked the goal.
That is... I think he's happy. He looks happy.
Mate, if you think... If he wins this match from here, if you don't think I'm not going to interview him, you're off your head. I haven't interviewed Joel yet. Now look at Joel.
Look at Mick.
No emotion at all from Joel.
Look at the seriousness on Mick's face, though.
Yeah, he knows he can lose his tournament now. And I'll tell you, if Joel happens to go on and win this match from here, then yes, he still needs two frames and momentum's with him, which is great. The change in player belief across the country will be huge. And then suddenly Mick will know he doesn't have the factor, just the aura of unbeatableness in a race to 11 that he has at the moment.
Well, that's exactly it. A lot of times people don't think things are possible until somebody's actually gone and done it.
I'll tell you what as well. Someone has had a fair bit of money on Mick Hill as well, when it's on $1.35. I don't know who that was, but they're going to be... Their cheeks are pretty clenched right now. And Travis Crawley, I don't know how many people have backed Joel in comparison. He doesn't even look worried, he's just not even watching. So who broke that? Mick? Another dry break?
I didn't see it.
He's racking the balls up.
Yep.
Another dry break. That's unbelievable. That's the most amount of dry breaks I've ever seen. Tell me Robbo is at home right now screaming the house down.
He's like, I got put on the wrong table.
He would have thrown remote controls, picked up bottles of glasses and skull water and thrown them at the sink 100 miles an hour. Told Susie, look at this, what's going on here? Why didn't I get these chances last night? Telling his kids all about it. Look at it, are you watching his kids?
Lucky they don't have a dog, I might have got the kick.
I'm telling you now, Robert, the best thing you can do to make yourself calm if you're fuming about the situation is go and play a game of League of Legends.
He might be watching Neil.
I actually don't think Robert ever watches Neil play.
Last I heard it was 8-all, I think.
Against who?
Foo. Oh.
Foo's actually one person that Neil's had a bit of trouble beating over the years. My memory serves me correctly. Colby's had that much result in this match, but I actually can't see her losing because she's not playing well. Look at this shot from Renata.
Off its head.
It's a big call that I've just made there, but she is not even look like being in this match, and she's 4-all.
So what's Joel's options here?
On the yellows.
Can he see the bottom line?
I think you need to take this plant on.
Well, he's got the momentum.
Exactly. It's a tough plant. He's taking it on. What a shot!
Oh my goodness! How?
That right there.
Pure confidence.
Shot of the day. Close to shot of the tournament, other than that plant that Mick Hill played the other night. That is one of the best plants under pressure over distance you'll ever see, especially on this pocket cut.
This is the thing about this game though, Jamie. I guarantee you, Joel doesn't take that shot on when he's 1-5 down.
Of course not.
You know
he's actually
I mean?
Looking for a tree to hide behind, but he couldn't find one. You've got to take it on anyway and then misses it by, you know, half a pocket.
The balls in the game are exactly the same. It's just the state of mind that's changed.
That's all right. Oh no, that's a bad shot.
No, mate, come on.
Why he didn't just come off the back rail there is beyond me. Just come off the back rail.
This is not that bad though, Jamie. He can stun this in and come across.
You're right. It's just you've got to play a long range shot now, whereas you wouldn't have had to before.
Yeah, that's true. But this is all right. If he makes this shot.
He's clearly played for that. Because he hardly hit the wide at all. You know,
It's a good angle. You've just got to make the pot.
I agree.
Yeah. Great shot from Joel Younger. And he has a perfect angle to run through for the middle here, Pikey. I reckon the white ball's going down table a little bit and he's got perfect angle to place for the black in the centre.
He's having a look at the black in the middle.
Mate, even I'm starting to get buzzing about this. Well, who do you think?
I think
this is huge. Can you believe that Joel Younger is one black away of going to the hill and
against
doubling
the hill.
Hill score? Against the hill, yeah. All I can say, ladies and gentlemen, is WTF. Tell me he looks like missing at the moment.
On the hill, against the hill.
He is queuing so well.
Oh. Can the question now, Jamie, I mean, sorry, can McHill answer this? Can he come back?
Well, the thing is, Joel has three more breaks. So Joel only has to run one rack, and Mick has no say in the outcome of this match now.
This is a pretty unique situation, though. You don't get to see Mick behind this much.
And the other thing too is he's queuing a ball that well at the moment. He's played probably 30 pots that don't even look like missing in the last sort of four or five frames. Split turn out for Joel. Oh, that was close to an off. Oh, of course he has to dry break at this critical moment in the match and create a possible chance for a comeback. And look what Mick's doing right now. He's trying to make light of the situation, change the tempo, settle himself down.
I saw him talking to the crowd between the end of the frame too.
He actually does that. I've seen him do that at world titles before when he's losing. He starts talking to people in the crowd.
Yeah.
He's got to be as cold as ice right now. He hasn't been to the table pretty much before, right?
So it's all about getting behind that ball up the top too, Jamie.
Yeah. Now the humour part's done now for Mick. He's back on let's get this done mode.
Might nudge the yellow off the red here. Oh, what a class shot that was.
And not only that, he's left perfect.
What a class shot that was. The control there was beautiful.
But the best part about it is left his in perfect angle to drop onto the dodgy red at the top end of the table.
That's what I mean. It's... You know, he didn't go into that.
He needs one more class shot after this for Pike, and that's to land on this ball on the right hand side of the table. It's dodgy.
They actually link up, though. He takes that, then he takes that middle. He wanted to have a little bit more angle than that.
Yeah, I think so. How's his angle? Oh, no, he's got angle.
It's not much, though.
He'll be able to just use a tracer right inside to swing the white ball back up.
I reckon you'll find he only brings the white ball up to around the balk line.
I reckon he'll get a bit higher than that. It's all about the line.
Oh, he's hit that so well.
How's the line? Is he on this?
Yeah, he has hit that so well. Yeah. And that's the difference with his... Because he's got such good cue ball control. He gets up on the shots. You know, he doesn't leave himself the missable shots.
Yeah,
like,
the
distance,
that's right.
Three-quarter table shot.
So here we go. Joel's dry breaks. Mick's break next. This frame's over, folks. There's no way Mick's going to chop this frame up. Oh, I think Colby snookered herself like that, actually. Oh, it's Renata.
Yeah. You got to give him a clap for this one, don't you, Jamie? Oh, it's not bad.
How's the form here? We've got all the pubs right next to us. Apparently, a change of nationality is allowed.
I've got the message off Kev Harvey. He said, Joel Younger, indomitable will.
Indomitable. Derby Bulls about to go into the lead for the first time in the match, providing she doesn't chop this up.
Just got another message in from Taz. He said, Joel won 8 frames in a row without missing a ball, and Mick Hill did 4 dry breaks.
Oh, Mick has still not potted a ball off the break, and look at the balls.
See, those yellows are tasty.
I like reds, Mikey.
Yeah?
Yeah, we've got a difference in opinion for the first time. I like the reds, but I'm often wrong.
Well, I mean, there's an argument for both here. Like, the question is...
I just think the yellow near the black there is dodgy.
I mean, you've got plenty of reds to open up the black as well.
I'm awesome.
Okay.
For the first time since 2004.
He's got to open up the black here too, though, with the...
I just think he doesn't need to do too much because he's got these reds to just get a small little nudge.
He might even have the angle now, Jamie. He might even have the angle now to play the middle of the three reds and stun into the yellow just behind the black.
Yep.
Just a soft nudge, and you're on both reds.
I think Joel has won big guns twice, Dan. In fact, it might have been 2 years in a row. Oh, that's no good.
He tried the shot I said, but didn't quite have the angle for it.
So now, pot the red that's to the right of the black and yellows. Give yourself an angle on the ball on the ball in the bottom row, pot it and cannon the yellow to the right of the black, and be on the ball in the middle. Do you like it?
I do.
You just got to be careful not to cannon it too hard, because you don't want it to flick off the other red and go near the red. No, sorry, flick off the yellow above it and then go towards the red.
He's not playing real short. He's played for a nudge there. Things are a little tricky now, Jamie. This is why I would have gone yellows.
I would like to have seen how tricky they got on yellows as well. Still wouldn't have taken that shot myself, but anyway, we'll see what happens. Big break there from Colby. Except it's just horrible as far as potting out's concerned. They've sort of clustered a little bit.
Joel's swinging round off the rails here.
That's very well controlled shot. Did you see him sort of drawing
up
the table
there? He wanted a little bit more pace in that.
Yeah, he wanted a bit of business. And I saw this shot a while ago. I just hadn't said anything about it yet because you're trying to pick the dead centre of the two yellows and let the white pull through and then nudge the black a little bit as well. It's a very tough shot.
Yeah, not ideal.
Oh. Colby's actually on. So I've got to ask, did she nominate reds or yellows there? Maybe she nominated yellows? Why would you try and hit it that thin? I reckon she's fouled, nothing's happened.
So ideally, Joel's got a bit of the angle that he needed now, but he's still got the red up the top.
Yeah, I reckon it's a foul, Dan, nothing happened. She nominated reds. That's strange. And I know Colby, and there's no way she would have cheated. I think she's just so focused, she's not even realised she's done it.
Oh.
No, his angle's okay.
He can screw into the yellow behind the one sort of beside the black spot.
No, I can see his angle here. He's got plenty.
He can screw into the yellow just beside the black spot here. Take it off the back of the black. You don't want to hit it too hard, Jamie. You just want to move that yellow.
Yeah, just land on it, basically. Yeah. Bit of a replacement shot.
So, you just nudge into the yellow. Hit it. Like that.
Oh, it's a big shot coming up here on the black.
I'm going with...
Can you hit this thin enough?
He will pot this, Jamie. I'm going.
You reckon he can get enough of the black without hitting the yellow?
Yep.
I reckon you're right, Pikey, and I reckon he's going to get this too. He's having another look. This is all about getting through the white ball nicely.
He doesn't have to worry about the yellow going in or the white going in.
Big shot coming up. He's missed it.
We've mozzed him.
You see what happens? We've spoken all weekend about if you don't take your chances against McKill, you lose matches. He's had a chance to win the match right there and then. 6-10 up. He's probably going about to go 7-10.
You know, is he drop snookering, Jamie?
No, he's potting out. He's potting out for sure. And
looking pretty good here.
Yeah, this frame's now over. We'll go to 10-7 very shortly. I would actually feel sick for Joel if he just doesn't get over the final hurdle after how well he's just played. And we don't want, and for his sake, he doesn't want to see a momentum shift, although I can sense a potential momentum shift starting to occur.
And, well.
And at the moment, it's destination McKill land.
You like the way McKill's overplayed that to get up onto that ball? He's got plenty of backup if he doesn't get on it. He does that quite often.
He does it a hell of a lot, you're right.
You know, a lot of people, they play to get up on the other one and then on the hard one. Mick does it the first shot. And the end of his outs are always so much easier because of it.
Yeah, he'll play a stun run through here.
He's really hit that in with a bit of affirmation, Jamie.
Affirmation, Pike? Can you stop the multiple syllable words? I'm getting confused. It is Joel's break.
A few folks starting to talk about pressure. Pressure's when you got six kids and no job and you've got to feed them all. This is just a game, Jamie.
I think pressure's when you haven't had it taken a dump for a week. Mikey, that's pressure.
What does Johnny Farnham say? Take the pressure.
Under pressure.
Who's Rusty barracking for? Well,
pretty obvious, I
think. I don't know. I don't know whether Rusty likes Joel's style either.
He doesn't.
It'll be so Joel with the break. He winds up, crunches the pack. Oh, they haven't split well, but he's potted
balls.
He's potted one.
Oh, it's horrible. It's horrible. He won.
It's horrible. It's horrible, but it's not, Jamie.
I know what you're saying.
If you can squeeze a red in behind that corner yellow, things start to open up.
Do you know something? There is not a chance in a million years right now that Joel is thinking about getting a ball over high and taking control of his frame. He wants to try and work out a play at the end of the match. Even though it might not be exactly the correct mindset of the balls are no good, he wants to finish the match. He's looking for an extraction. There's no doubt about it.
Well, I still think he can get the red in behind that yellow, Jamie.
Oh, I'm not disagreeing with you. I just don't know if he'll do it.
He might...
I honestly think it's the correct shot, Mike. Yeah, the great Mick Scarry's just checked in. We would have talked more about Mick, but he's underachieved in the tournament.
Yeah. I think it was the affirmation.
Oh.
The affirmation quote. Mick doesn't mind potting a few balls with a bit of affirmation.
Affirmation.
Yeah.
That's no good. That is no good. I just can't say authority because I just keep thinking of Cartman. Oh, South Park.
Maybe this will teach you to listen to authority.
And I can't say his voice at all. I'm the worst impersonator on the planet.
He might put this in front of the black, Jamie.
Jeez, what a shot from Colby.
Yeah. So
sadly for her, she's got to play another giant shot and then another giant shot again.
Have a look at this. Mick's turned the screws here. He's covered the black. He's red's ugly. Oh.
See, this is...
You certainly can't get away with potting Mick's yellow over the hole here, can you?
No, not really. But can you punch the red and just dislodge him?
I'm not loving potting balls here, Jamie.
I think he's just trying to get himself in a position to do something about it.
I am not loving potting balls here. I don't...
How about...
I don't see where he's going with this. What's he going to do? Pot all the balls, markers, double the last red?
Tell you what, there,
pot the black.
There is a lot of handbags getting thrown out there on that match. Handbags getting thrown left, right and centre in the women's game over there. They're having a bit of a struggle town fest.
I'm not sure. I'm still not sure where he's going with this, Jamie.
I don't know. Maybe he's going to try and dismount it now.
No, surely not.
Maybe it does, you know. Maybe it does squeeze.
He's looking at it now.
I reckon it might just maybe squeeze it in, but doesn't pop.
Yeah, he's looking at it.
I just don't see him.
That must be the reason. It must be able to get it in front.
Well, at the end of the day, while you've got those two, it's no good. You know what? I'd actually punch that. Just get him out. I mean, you've got two dodgy guys at the other end of the table. Well, he's still got to deal with him.
Well, Mick, I think Mick will drop this right over the pocket.
Probably.
You know what I like about that? He's also sort of made it where Joel can't really pot it.
Yeah, but the thing is, if he was going to pot it, he would have done it three shots ago.
Yeah.
It's the same, but the balls haven't moved for Mick. The same spot.
And maybe that's Mick's sense that. Maybe he's said, well, Joel's not going to pop my ball, so...
You know what I'd do? I'd double the red out. I'd just double the red out.
That's a good shot, really.
It's not bad. I'll tell you why I don't like it. Because Mick's going to basically promote the upper yellow on the ball in the rail, and then he's going to play the other one down the rail.
Yeah.
And if as long as he hits the inside of the red, his yellow goes in and the other yellow stays there that he's hit.
Or he can do the opposite, hit it half ball and the other yellow goes out of the way.
Yeah, that one's a bit out of control. I cannot believe the amount of missing that is going on this girl's
I wouldn't be surprised if Mick Hill makes this first pot too.
Yeah, exactly. Colby's, I'll tell you, she is getting just a strawberry fest out there at the moment.
He hasn't made the first pot. So, couple of options.
There you go, you got a buyer.
Does Mick play the snooker?
No, I'm not interested much.
Does Mick play the snooker here, Jamie?
I think he does.
So Joel in a world of hurt this frame.
Yes. See what I mean? It was 10-5 before. It's looking
10-8.
Close to 10-8.
With Mick's break.
Yeah. And the pressure, it can only be building on Joel.
Mind you, Mick's break hasn't been an advantage so far.
But the momentum swing might change that.
So
it's a good shot. It's a great shot.
He's made contact with a red.
See, now he's lining this up. I have to be honest with you, if I'm Mick Hill, I actually don't show that hand. You know what I mean? I don't show that I'm going to do that.
Oh, I think he was going to do it anyway, so...
He played that control really well. That was a good shot.
He'll play this pretty firm, and he'll play it on the outside of the red.
You're right. Oh, see, I'd play it on the inside myself.
Because there's plenty of room for that yellow to come out into the open.
Yeah, fair call. Why risk trying to hit it neat on the inside when you can just punch it and get it right out of there?
And it hasn't come past.
He's played it perfect. Nothing wrong with it.
It goes both the middle and the corner, but
Well, he's going to be playing the bottom right corner. There's no doubt about it. It doesn't matter because it's going to be his last, well, second last ball now.
That was interesting.
I like that. He's basically said, I've got the angle now. Why pop the ball over the hole and risk not getting the angle? I'll just deal with it now. I mean, at the end of the day, he can stun back up the table now, come off side cushion and just...
Maybe that yellow up the top's a bit further out from the pocket than it looks on camera.
No, you can see it from here. It's...
Yeah.
I think this is the right shot.
Hey, he's going to swing around the two angles here.
Look, at the end of the day, he knows if he just lands slightly right of centre table, he's got a pretty basic shot of it. So he's happy with that.
Yeah, what's interesting about that, like a lot of people would have cut that in thin and come back up, but he swings around with the natural...
I would swing around that for sure.
Natural side. That's one thing with Mick Hill, you learn to say natural side, because he plays everything with the running side, you know, just runs onto shots with the weight of the ball.
So 10-8 now, and this is starting to become a bit sickening in the stomach for Joel Younger if he...
I'll tell you what, how good is this for everyone out there watching, though? Entertainment.
What's a 6-all with Lauren Jelly and Lyndall Morford, if anyone was interested?
Even then...
Yeah, he's not timing the break at all.
He was tight on that break.
He's just bashing it.
Yeah, he was tight on it.
Yeah, he's bashing the break. He's not timing it at all. Joel's got a huge chance on yellows here. Look at these. He's sick. Joel can't ask for more at the moment to close this match out. Cannot ask for any more than what he's getting.
Definitely had a chance.
Meanwhile, Robbo's still sitting at home. Scream at the TV. Why isn't the ball going in off his break? Why did this happen to me? Why did I get born with red hair?
Oh, Joel's overhit that, but...
Come on, mate.
Why aren't I left-handed like my brother?
Ooh.
Why did Mick go and get married?
Okay.
Do we need any more, or we got the point? Good shot there from Joel. Just having a real good look at where he wants to land with this wide here, because this is... This, after he pots his ball in the middle, it's the key shot for the match coming up. He's running through.
Where's this guy?
He's playing the plan.
Okay.
For some reason, he wanted an angle rather than to be straight on it. I'm not sure what the deal is with that yet.
It's probably easier to be on a ball playing it from this angle.
I'd much rather be straighter on it. Yeah, if I can play it, just drag it down there, get through the ball. It's hard to get through the ball because the light's going to be moving a little bit here. I reckon this is easy. Played it well.
Oh, I don't know. This is awkward. This is awkward.
Meanwhile, Danny O's screaming at the football. It's been a minute in and he's going off his nut. Richmond Demons playing, and obviously he's a Demon supporter, but it's the first minute, Danny O. Calm down, mate. You know what I don't like about this out, Pikey?
The fact that he's bridging over the red.
Other than that, you have to get up on this ball on the right inside now. You know you can't land on the ball inside right and screw it in. You know it's not going to go. It will not go.
You've really got to punch this. And
got to get
bridging over the top of the red, it's not easy.
You've got to get past the centre pocket up here. That's what you've got to do. I'm not kidding. You've got to get higher than the centre pocket.
He's done it. He has done it. He's got the angle to
he's
come.
Got the angle to come across. He's good. Do not dare screw that ball in, Joel. I will punch you in the face. He knows the table. He knows that it's going to be a roll in and he's going to have a
shot on the black.
Yeah. And you know what? If he pots this and does get across the table for the yellow.
Have a look at Mick Hill's face. He's biting his bottom lip right now.
That's a good shot. And he's got an excellent roll in angle. Do not try and punch off this or screw. Just give yourself that.
I'm tipping this will be a pocket weight shot, Jamie.
If this is not pocket weight, he'll miss the ball. Oh, he's missed it. That was a genuine miss, folks. He just overcut it. Just overcut it a little bit.
Yeah. Well. So you are.
I never like leaving balls on the rail to last. How many times I've missed a ball down the rail, whether it be the black or the last ball to win the match or whatever, it just drives me insane.
As the nerves of steel here.
What's he going to do with his ball at the top?
I think he's looking for a snooker, don't you?
Yeah, I think he is. And he's going to want to do it sooner rather than later, so he doesn't want to remove the traffic for the cross table. Look at Colby, she's going off over there. She's 7-4 now. I've just watched a misfest over there every time I've watched her. But at the end of the day, Colby's the one that's closing the match out.
He's going for game here, Jamie.
There we go, Colby. Well done.
Colby Poole is now on the hill.
How big is this out in, you know, like... It's easy to say, oh, you know, Joel's missed this frame's mixed, but you go out there and you do this at 8-10 down in the semi-final of the big guns.
Colby will actually win that match over there. Now, there are way too many mistakes happening out there. Way too many. He'll pop this. Glass! Oh, glass, says one of the pommies. Glass! There's no glass out there.
He's ended up a bit straight on this, Jamie.
He is a bit straight. Actually, no, you know what? I actually think he's got the side rail past the middle pocket to come out. I reckon he's okay. I reckon he can get back centre table to play the red that's just above the black. I'm wrong.
He's straight on this. He's going to screw all the way back here, Jamie.
Oh, this is a big shot.
He's going deep screw.
Or does he play the snooker?
No, he's going deep screw, I'm telling you.
Oh, he's running through. He's actually, close topspin shot very well. Hey, deep screw is much harder to play than the run
and harder to control where you land. Like, if he lands here, he pots the two reds in the middle and he's on the black.
No, the black. I reckon the black's on. No, it's not on. It's not on.
He is filthy.
Wow, hey. He's going to need to screw back in between black and lower red, and this needs to be cued spot on. This is a much harder shot than it looks.
Come on. He's got a shot on it, Jamie.
I don't think it's cuttable, is it?
It's cuttable.
Oh, it is cuttable. It's thin.
Where's that white going?
Where's the cue ball going to be going? And if I was whispering Ted Lowe, this shot for a place in the grand final.
This is planet Earth.
John, actually, I think whispering Ted Lowe, I don't do too bad.
Get it!
He's pot it. And it's in. Mick Hill has won the match. And folks, history has been made. The camera's just been knocked to the shit out. But we still have one more match in play, folks. Actually, two more matches in play. Colby and Renato haven't finished yet.
Wow.
Oh, We've got a record. We've got a record viewing, 674. So we have had a lot of people witness history being made in Australian 8-ball. Mick Hill for the first time has lost and been knocked out of a tournament and raced to 11. Interviews will follow shortly after we finish the women's games. There will be a break in between the grand final, I'm sure. And now Mick Hill is going to line up and post-mortem himself, playing his ball down the rail.
He's missed it three times now.
I've been saying all weekend these pockets are tough. So Colby Poole is about to break off. She is, what is she, 7-4 up now? Is that right, 7-4? Yep, 7-4 is. She's on the hill, she's playing for the, breaking for the match. I don't think I've seen one clearance or even close to a clearance in this match yet, so will this be the time? And this is absolutely no disrespect for the women's game, but Joel has just put on a semi-masterclass out there and made the game look stupid easy at points in that match. You're probably not going to get that right now. There's going to be a lot of tenseness in both ladies' arms. Colby's on the hill, she needs one more frame. I'll tell you what's going through Mick's head at the moment. My flight home just doubled in price. Because I was expecting it to be free from the tournament money I was about to make. Yeah, he was playing in Anzac.
Still a nice paycheck, really, for third place.
Oh.
Well, actually, is third and fourth the same, or do they have to play off for it?
I'm pretty sure it's the same money.
Yeah.
So Colby here faced maybe with a cut in the middle straight up, or a double if she wants to pull the wide. She's going to play the cut. Red will just push down and the wide will come back through.
Brett's not happy. He owes you a dollar.
Oh, yeah. What odds was that? 96,000 or something? Brett, you don't owe me a dollar. You owe me like $96,000. 3,000, third and fourth place. So Mick's covered his flight, huh? Now they've put the music on, and it's going to be really hard for the 20-second calls, and you know Colby's going to be stressing out about that. He's already rushing his shot. Yeah, that was rushed. That's all that was, just rushing. I'm actually going to go put that music, get that music turned off.
You got some authority around this joint, Joe.
Bloody oath, mate. What do I say goes, apparently. No, I just asked nice. I said, look, they've got to hear the 20-second call. I said, it doesn't sound like much, but 30 seconds compared to 20 is massive. If you've got to hear the call anyway. Well, I'm just dying to get Joel in for an interview.
Oh, yeah.
We might actually see him smile.
I don't think Mick will be too keen for an interview.
No, look, I think I will interview him, though. No, he's a professional. This is what he does for a living, and he's lost before. He'll cop it on the chin and move on. And he's still got the Anzac Day tournament to try and recoup some cash. But he's now vulnerable, though, to the world. To Australia. Eight frames in a row, Joel won. How many did he actually run in a row? Three or four? Someone at home has kept count of this, and they've counted how many racks Joel actually ran in the whole match and in a row. I want to know what it is, because it's important for the interview. I'm going to bring it up.
Well, he won the eight frames in a row.
Yeah, he won eight in a row, but how many of them were actually off the break, as in not just his, but Mick's as well, for dry breaks? How many in total and how many in a row?
Be interesting to see how he changed in his mind, you know what I mean? How he felt during the match.
Yeah.
You know, the confidence building and the momentum and then the nerves at the end trying to get over the line.
I'm not sure who's 7-6 up in the Lindell's 7-6 up against Lauren Jolly.
And Lindell's got the black over the pocket.
And as you can see, folks, this is much slower pace. The balls are very congested at the moment in this frame. Our viewers has actually gone from 770 or whatever it was, Pikey, down to 430 as soon as that match finished. I kid you not. That's a bit disrespectful to the girls. All right, I'm going to be back in a sec. I'm sick of Danny yelling. I'm going to go and abuse him.
Colby's just missed the double there. It was almost in.
I just learned two things about Danny O then, Pikey. One, he knows nothing about football. And two, I've just had a $50 note on that outcome of that match just to shut him up. And it probably still won't work.
Tell you what, Lauren Jolly's in a bit of trouble over there. Lindell's got the black over the pocket.
Ooh, she's not got a snooker there. She's given access to the top yellow for Colby. And if I'm Colby here, I'm running off the left-hand side of the shell. I'm doubling at centre table, just past the centre pocket. I reckon she can see it. Oh, she fit a truck through there. The one at the top left hand, this one. So left hand side here, double it to the center of the table, just take the white ball over the left side of the table. Wow, why would you try and cut that? This is what I call trying to close the match out as soon as possible with some crazy shots. I'll tell you what it has done though, it's actually a massive result where it's landed because it stops Renato from playing the ball down the rails, a bit of a shot to nothing. Now Renato actually has to get this pretty neat over the hole if she's trying to sit it.
Tell you what, this
she's
is good.
It. Renato's in trouble.
This is do or die for Lauren Jelly.
Oh, it's a ball down the rail. This is like,
And she's just 4 foot away from it.
Mate, this is like $9 on these tables to go in. She pots this, it's huge. She's dragging it. No, she's playing a plain ball. I'm going to say she's no chance to pot this. These tables are ridiculous. Yeah, that's jawed. Oh, she's got the jaw snooker.
Oh, no, it's just
not
bounced
quite.
Out.
Good shot there from Renata. She's also made the black awkward. And I'll tell you what. Could go game here.
Lyndall Morfitt has defeated Lauren Jelly.
So Lyndall Morfitt will be the first person to be in the Big Guns Ladies Final.
8-6.
I've got a lot of interviews to do. I don't know if I'm going to get through them all.
So Renata's laid up there.
Yeah, it was a good fight there from Lauren.
So can Colby... Can Colby get this black out, or...?
Do you really need to, though, Pike? Can you just get behind it and play it in the middle? Oh, why are you playing this ball first if you're going to pot out, though?
She's getting down onto the...
You reckon she's going to try and extract it?
No.
All right. So she's got on this ball now, so she's going to use the ball at the top of the table to get on the black, so she's going to have to move the ball, the white ball, a good 5 feet and land perfect in the corner. Is that what the plan is here, Pikey?
Well, has she got a free shot to screw off this and get the black out? Need a good shot. Bit of cue power.
Looks like you're right, but I guess that's exactly what she's doing.
She's tried. Oh, no.
I'm sorry, but for all money, it's just not the right shot.
Oh, no.
I'd have been potting the ball on the top first, coming back to the centre, then come down this ball and just try and play it to the middle. And if you don't like the shot, you can even play for a double. Do you know what I mean? Like... This frame's still a bit of work to do, though, even with two. I'll tell you what, the quicker Danny O loses his voice, the better for Australia. Good shot there from Renata. She's come out.
That is a nice shot. You can nudge that one that's beside the black out into the middle and be on the other one.
Got to give it a bit.
Yeah.
And you don't stun this because you actually hit the red square. So you actually want to go into it. She stunned it, but she's hit it square.
Chinese snooker.
Should hopefully be okay for her sake.
Awkward queuing.
Has two shots though, so realistically doesn't even have to pot at this shot as long as she has a shot at next shot.
Well, I don't think she really wants to pot at this shot because unless she...
She's played it well. She's not the tallest lady in the world, Renata, either, so it's a good shot.
One for the midgets.
So this is very key, this positional shot right now. So I'm actually playing this ball. I'm going to actually overcut the natural potting angle, and I'm going to play it with just a very small trace of left-hand side pike, just to pull it away from the rail.
I think so, about half ball, and you just up the rail. Oh, she's played for the middle.
Oh, what were you thinking?
I was going to screw up past the black, play it down in this...
You are off your head.
You reckon?
Yeah, I played it in the middle all day. You don't have to do anything. There's no skill shot required.
This angle on the pot is slightly missable.
Well, I would have liked to come across a little bit further, but...
That's a good shot.
So, one more black for Renata to go 7-5 and stay alive in the tournament. And that is in, so Renata will keep this match alive.
Bit blurry through the bottles.
They also.
Yeah, I can't see to the bottles there. I reckon we should play out the way. Raise the 5, the 100, one hand. It's up to the so we've got to double every 3 shot.
Good effort,
Jim. I know. I was just waiting to see what it was. What are you going to do to your legs up yet? Get up like that.
Can you hold this for me?
Get it back, buddy. Stop breaking
this. Look at all the Colby has ball in hand, Jamie.
And what a massive break. The balls have just gone everywhere.
The sarcasm is just dripping from your tongue there, Jamie.
But in fairness, if she can get an angle on this ball, the yellow that's above the pack, where she could just
crunch the line.
She decided to just go through the gap and land on nothing. That's not an option I'd have taken personally, but if she was actually going for the pack there, why didn't she give it a bit?
Yeah, well, I don't know. I'm wrong. I've got one coming. Here we go.
So Colby's not giving herself a lot, so it's going to be a bit of a plan B shot. And well, she's sort of got the white sort of buried in the sort of the above the pack, but I think she's promoted the red to leave Renata on it.
Sort of buried. That white is 6 foot under, Jamie.
The only problem is, for Renata, is she doesn't want to pop many balls here because otherwise she's just going to start digging a grave for yourself. There is... I would still pot this ball in the middle and screw across the centre table for the ball down the rail and just probably put it over the hole if I was going to predict a possible shot for Renata here. I am wrong. No surprises there.
Yep. Two rails take the ball off the side cushion.
But this is what I'm saying, Pikey. That I don't see the point in potting balls right now. Unless there's an out on that. I mean, I can't, don't get me wrong, I can see a way to pot out here, and it involves getting on the red that's just below the black, and then you can use that to get into the pack and open it up a bit.
What about now? Has she got the angle to force crunch the pack open?
No. She's just off straight, but the force crunch probably would just make him shiver. Scare him into moving.
There's plenty of pool left in this frame, Jamie.
Yeah, and I think Renata's recognised, you know what, this ball's dodgy, I'm going to deal with it now, and she's almost potted it. That's a good shot. She cut that really nicely. And I think she'd be happy with it being over the hole there. The follow-up shot wouldn't have been desirable. Now, what does Colby do here? Probably the shot I'd have played too.
It's great
just,
shot.
Yeah, just run a ball down there and get a bit of a security blanket in play. Now the question for you, Pike, is do you pot the yellow over the hole? Do you take the risk and say, you know what, Colby, I want you to open the balls up and have a dip at a really hard out?
Well, see, it's an interesting scenario because it's a different style of game the women play. Like, they don't necessarily look for the opportunities to take the moment and go.
Oh, I tell you what, she can actually leave her a foul snooker here. I just realised this is very foul. Oh, she's going around. That's definitely a foul snooker now.
There's no maybe about it.
So if I'm Colby here...
You're putting the red over the pot?
Surely she's seen it. If she hasn't seen this foul snooker, I'll seriously fly over the top of this monitor and knock her out.
You pop the red over the pocket, don't you? Or do you take ball in hand?
No, I take ball in hand. I get rid of the dodgy ball, okay? And then I'm going to play the yellow that's above the pack into the red fairly full, and it's just going to nicely spread everything open.
Mm-hmm. I like it. You can also land high on this yellow, pot it in the middle, and open the pack
up. You know what? I actually like that shot better, Pikey. The only reason I might not like it is you've got to land perfect, whereas the shot I've said, you just got to land behind her and just play a controlled shot. But she's played your shot, and she's landed good angle.
She might be a touch higher than she wanted, but...
I think you actually want to stun on the black here now.
I don't know if she's got that much angle, is she?
No, I reckon she does. Oh, yeah, problem is the white ball's too close to the rail, yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, you know what? It's actually inexcusable that close to the rail, because she could have put the white ball wherever she wanted, and she's landed there.
Yeah.
Good pop, but wrong ball.
Mm. Yeah, it was because of the angle she had. She didn't quite have the...
But still...
You can clip off this... Just open the cluster.
There's a new one. I think you run off this at enough angle to come off bottom cushion, side cushion,
yep,
and back out.
Around the two reds.
Yeah. Could play the push shot, Pikey.
Well.
Just go through it. That's what she's going to do, I think. Oh, no, she's going to jack up and just stun middle table. I like this shot. That's a good shot.
Except for the black going to the rail, but it's a good shot.
Hey, Pikey.
What?
Play the left-hand yellow into the corner. That's very close to the dismount on the black. I think the red might be in the way.
Can she cut this yellow in the middle and run round off two and be on the yellows back into the centre?
I reckon she just cannoned straight into the red. I reckon she's cannoned straight in the red this time.
She's hitting it pretty thin.
No way. Look at that. Oh, the other red.
You called it.
I actually called her top red. That's a poor positional shot. I didn't like the shot, regardless of what angle she had there, unless it was really straight to screw back for these other two yellows. I didn't like any shot where the white ball was
she
running at all.
She may not
there.
Even be on this pot, Jamie. Have a look from over the top of the monitor.
She is.
She's on it?
She's just been blessed. Very, very fortunate. But it's still a lot of work to do. Even if this goes in, she's got to pop the last yellow and get position on the black.
Does the last yellow go back between the reds?
I'm pretty sure that one does. Oh, she's overcut it. Maybe it didn't go. Don't know. I mean, she's overcut it, so. Now, if I'm Renata here, I pot the upper of the two on the left-hand side of the table, and I try and land fairly parallel with the red, and then I'm going to play an extraction on the black.
You know what I do, Jamie? I find a way to put a red onto the black, push the black up near the dodgy red.
But all the balls are on. Why do you need to do that? Like, if you just get a good angle...
To extract the black.
Yeah, just pull it out off the rail.
Yeah.
I know it's really easy to sit here and talk about it, but to me... even if you fall lower on it, you're still going to be able to manipulate the white to get the cannon. And you don't have to hit it hard. You've just got to make sure you catch a half ball. As long as you don't hit it full and then, you know, move it past the centre pocket up the rail. As long as it comes out away from the cushion. Meanwhile, Colby is presented with not such a pleasant shot. She's got to actually layer up here, go around the angles. Look at this. Oh!
She's had to go.
I think she had to play it. Not afraid to layer up, Colby. Where's that finish line? It's so close.
Mm.
She wants to finish it.
I think Travis has just been swarmed.
By?
The debt collectors.
Oh, the payouts are in progress. Oh, I wonder if Sarwin's left yet. He owes me money. So, tricky this for Renata because she's presented with an out, but a black. Well, she has to pot or she's probably going to lose the match.
Well, see, this is the problem. This is why I would have liked to be able to push the black up towards that safe red with one of the reds.
Well, yeah, in hindsight now, but that's because she missed the opening pot. Mm-hmm. Not bad.
Not good.
No, it's not bad. No, it's not good. It's very difficult to transition to black now. Unless you can click this red and thin and come in line with the balk line.
I tell you what about cutting this red in the middle and kicking the black off the cushion?
Do you reckon it's on?
Oh.
I reckon she's slipping past the black. Yeah, I think she goes past it.
Plus, it's a big shot.
It's a very big shot. Over. So she's hit the. She's got thin, but she's actually
she's,
over here.
She's played for the angle now, Jamie.
You reckon that's what it is? Actually, now the angle is on.
It's a mighty thin nick on the red.
No, I don't think it is.
It's on. I think the angle's on, Jamie.
Yeah, you're probably right. It's that thin, the cut. But you're not going to take it on. It's off its head.
You're just going to cut it down in front of the yellow, aren't you?
Yeah. Well, you got to be careful where the white's going. I think that's a shot you play. Oh, hasn't hit it well.
She
did go for the cut.
She went for it.
You know what? She has slightly overcut that, or undercut it.
Overcut.
She's overcut it, which means she would have hit the black, yeah, if she pot it, because she comes short. No, she wouldn't have. She would have. She might have. Oh, she's undercut it then. Okay, so she's undercut it, so she would have hit the black. Right, Pike, you're right, it was on. And Colby plays good a snooker. Good snooker there. Normally she's got the touch of a baby elephant, but that's a good shot.
I think really Renata just wants to touch up on this red. You don't want to kill the red, do you?
Yeah, I agree. Actually, you know what? I don't agree.
You don't?
Well, if you touch up on this, look at the angle you leave on this yellow.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. But then you got to get the black out and get on the yellow.
You give it a bit. But
what's she doing here? She's going across table.
What's that? She's going to try and pot it.
She's played that with side.
Oh,
as well.
Good shot. That is a nice shot. However you stretch it, it's a good shot. I don't know why I said the word stretch then, Pike.
Well.
Might have been just thinking about what Joel just did to Mick.
Put him on the rack.
Stretched him. Oh, great shot from Colby. Has she got too much angle, Pikey?
Well, in a way, too much angle is not a bad thing because you can cut the black and leave the white over on the right-hand side cushion after
it. Yeah, it's true. She'd love to have the right angle here to just push the black down over the pocket. Surely she's not going to try and come off the bottom cushion and go into it.
No.
Oh, no. She's missed.
I think she's playing for, I don't want first shot at the black.
Yeah, that might be her best result.
she who has first shot at the black loses? Or
yeah, it could be.
They're tight down the cushion.
This is a lot worse for Renata, being that she can't really afford any more mistakes, whereas Colby can. Well, theoretically, you know.
And the problem is Colby's got that yellow there to get right on the black now, wherever Renata leaves it.
That's right.
So you really got to go for this.
What about just drop this in, play the smash double, screw up the rail?
Oh, this is good positional.
You can still play that shot, I just said.
What about the clip snooker, Jamie?
Nah. Too easy to go across table. Play the smash double, take the white ball at the other end of the table. Well, she's playing the Pikey special.
Well, I like the odds of this because Colby's still got to go across the table, pot it, and pot the black.
Yeah, pot the black down the rail is a tough gig. now she's reassessing and saying, well, actually, I don't think the smash double's on. I don't think you get the white ball out enough.
I got a mate who'd play the double all day here. And he's right behind me.
She's done it, but she's missed the pot.
I mean, at least with taking the double, you're taking it in your own hands.
Oh, for sure. You know, I don't think I would ever snooker there. I'd always try and get the white safe and have a dip at the black. Colby is... Surely, is she looking at going up and down here? She is. All right, to me, because the position on the black is not automatic unless she gives us a fair bit and she hits the angle perfect to go off the back rail and back on the table, to me, this is suicide.
It's funny how often people end up hitting those bottom two jaws when they play this
shot. I would just play to roll up on and hit the jaw.
Is she going up and down the
table? That's what I'm saying. This is suicide.
What is she doing?
That's absolutely suicide, that shot.
I mean, maybe she couldn't pot it from
this. Of course she couldn't, but this is a case of her trying to finish the match as far as she wants it over with. She wants it done. But just roll up onto the yellow.
Yeah, definitely.
She's just worried about giving another crack at the black, probably more than anything, and she nails it. She's trying to finish the frame herself. I understand it. I understand the thought process on that. 7-6. Renata actually has a bit of a reputation for big comebacks too. So for Colby's sake, let's hope that's not the case.
Danny O's still going off. Oh, mate, 40.
I thought he'd be hoarse by now. His voice is still running strong.
Seven six, Jamie.
I'm not sure what time the grand finals are scheduled for.
There's no
8:30. They got 26 minutes.
There was no Benny Noonan toilet break either.
No, I'm surprised she hasn't taken one. Ah, I knew it. Well, I'm going to see if I can get someone in for an interview real fast while they're having a break. Too much time on the head. Yeah. I drink
a little more. Yeah, that's about right. He'll be out of date.
Good, mate. It's a bowl.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this match has resumed, but I'm just going to, I was actually hoping to get Joel for an interview, but he has disappeared, probably just gone to freshen up and whatnot, get himself prepared for the final. So I'm going to grab the large head Jake McCartney and just have a quick word with him, because I don't think we've interviewed him yet. So I did actually ask Lauren Jelly if she was keen, but she's still just in, what do you call it, anyway. Aftermath mode, whatever you call it, you know, debrief mode, that's it. She's in debrief mode. Just, obviously still, she only just fresh lost probably 20 minutes ago, so give her a chance. McCartney lost about an hour ago now. I'm joined here with Jake McCartney, who made the semi-finals against all odds, I might say, as well, and ran into Rusty Wheeler, who must have hit a bit of form in the semis there, Jake, or do you have a different story to tell?
No, I agree 100%. Just of what I've watched from Rusty over the weekend, obviously he played his best match probably against me. In saying that, you know, early on I had a few chances that I didn't capitalise on, you know, and in the end, when you know, of a quality play like Rusty, when he's given a 7-2, you know, if not worse deficit, it's very hard.
Yeah, I mean, we didn't get to actually see the match at all on live stream. Obviously, you weren't on one of the televised tables, but we did see the score start to slip out. And you're right, it is difficult to reel it in, especially when they've got so many breaks. Would you say that's a huge factor, the break? You know, you're sort of expecting your opponent to run a few racks, especially if there's a big deficit?
Right. Yeah, correct. Especially at the business end too. You know, I've always, especially with the top liners, the cream's always going to rise to the top, and they break well and they get a ball. And even if they just get first, even if I break and I don't get a ball, you know, they get first look in, you know, it's a really big factor, I think. The break, you know, it has hurt me in patches all weekend. You know, in matches right at crucial times too, where I've come up dry, I've gone in off, you know, or, yeah, you know, and I've just given them first preference, you know, and then I've been behind the eight ball. But
did you, out of the other three players that are in the semi-finals, if you were to dig deep and ask yourself, who do I really want to play here, do you have a preference? I mean, most people are going to say, no, I don't really care who I play, but you've got better records against some people, you're more comfortable against other players. Did you have someone in mind that you thought, I wouldn't mind drawing this bloke now?
No, never. I've never had that attitude. I was in the room, and I was back in the room with Brad, and when we watched the draw get done live on Facebook, And he goes, you know, you've got Rusty, because, you know, you've got a bit of a good record on him lately. And I said, mate, you know, it means nothing to me. You know, it means nothing. You know, top few in the country, you know, take it, Mick Hill, of course. But, you know, it's a run of the ball. I find it's a run of the ball, especially that level of the top five and that. You know, if you're breaking well, you know, it's... I just seriously think that I didn't have a preference as far as playing anybody. You know, if you're going to win those comps, you've got to beat everyone. Yeah, you know, there's no point in saying that, you know, I don't want to play Rusty, I want to play Joel, I don't want to play Joel, I want to play Rusty. You know, when you're down the last four, you're at the business end, they're going to rise to the occasion, and you have to do it yourself. You know, you have to lift. And another thing I've always done is you never play the opponent. You know, you get seven balls in a black, and no, I'll take it frame by frame regardless of who I play.
Yeah, and speaking of not playing your opponent, you wouldn't have actually probably seen the entire match, but Joel Younger, obviously, you know, he's just knocked off Mick Hill, who's now the first person straight to do that in a race to 11 in a tournament. And it certainly appeared to me like he'd forgotten who he was playing there and got on with it, which I know is something you live by. What's your thoughts on that match, what you would have seen of it? And yeah, how do you think Mick's going to react to this?
I said at the start of a week ago, Brad and a few people actually did ask me who'd been in the tournament, and I said Joel. You know, I know he'd been playing a lot of snooker, and I spoke to Benny Noonan, you know, who lived down Geelong, and said, you know, he was playing really well the other week, and I honestly thought that Joel, yeah, he was my pick, you know, right at the start, you know, outside of Mick. You know, you can't write Mick off, you know, he's world class. You know, even when Joel was 10-5 or 10-6 up, you know, you might feel a little more comfortable playing nearly anybody else bar Mick. You know, it's not over, but, you know, take nothing away from Joel. You know, he's world class himself. You know, he's done everything, you know, nearly in all Q sports. You know, I think I class Joel as, you know, top, if not top, you know, one or two, you know, he's definitely top three in the country.
And final thoughts, even though you've already sort of said that you thought Joel would win the whole tournament. Brand new match, it's a grand final. You've seen the two players in the grand final.
Yep.
Your prediction of the winner and the score.
Joel, 11-6.
All right, thanks for your time, mate. Much appreciated. Shani.
Cheers, buddy.
Press the mute button.
He's my very best friend. I love him so much.
Stop it, mate. Get him up. Get him up. Get his
Sorry, folks, just having a bit of an aftermath chat. You done, are you, Pike? Two shots on Reds. Well, it's not the easiest out in the world, but you would assume that she's going to punch this red off the bottom cushion into these balls and maybe try and open them all up. Here it goes. Oh, look at the dream result.
That has come out well.
That has worked out an absolute treat for Colby Poole, and this little chop into the middle looks like it's just going to nudge the right-hand side of the red and land perfectly on her second-last red with an angle to stun back down the table for her final red. So I reckon, barring a large twitch or chop-up, this match could potentially be over. There's a little nudge I was talking about. and she's got the angle to stun. She basically, all she's got to do is clear just past the middle pocket. That's all she's got to do. Oh, maybe she is low on it. I think she's okay. I think she's got an angle to come back down the table, but we're going to know in a second when she plays a shot.
She might have to force it is the problem, Jamie.
Yeah, she doesn't play the four shot super well. She plays a different way than what I'm used to seeing, so... Nah, her angle is perfect. And she's cleared the centre pocket, like I said. So now all she's got to do is roll this in. And then not roll the black in, punch the black in. The only way she can possibly miss this black is by rolling it. That's right.
Affirmation.
This is not missing. She will punch this in. Guaranteed. She just doesn't roll balls in, Colby, unless it's dodgy sort of shot. But she'll punch this in and she'll make the final. In it goes. And she's in the final. And, well, I'd have to say I did predict Colby and Linda to make the final if they didn't draw each other. So we're going to see that not too far from now. So we'll take a break. I might see if I can get some more people to interview. And we'll take it from there.
Wait a minute, I'm all right.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with tournament director, organizer, entrepreneur, Travis Crawley. First of all, Trav, how do you think the tournament's gone?
I think the tournament's run quite well, Jamie. The response has been awesome. The quality of pool's been outstanding. It's just been a really good atmosphere, a good vibe. Everyone's enjoyed it, and we're finally at the end.
Yeah, now we've had new blood in as far as countries are concerned. Tons of New Zealanders have come over. I think there's about a dozen of them. A few guys from England have come over. You know, you've got Mick Hill again. He's just been knocked off. We've made history. Your thoughts on how things have gone, and did you think Mick Hill could lose?
Well, I actually did. I did think he could lose. After last year, a few of our lads went quite close. Mick, Stevie Woods, Rusty, they really took it to him, and we had the same players up against him again this time, especially with the format with the elimination semis. You only have to beat the guy once. So, we proved we can get close to him, and it was just a matter of someone taking the next step, and Joel did that now. And back on the New Zealand discussion, those guys really, they've come over here, some would have thought they'd just have a good time, but they come here to play, and they really showed up with some solid game. And a few of these guys really put their hand up to be noticed, and they stuck it to a few of our guys. So
yeah, well, I mean, as you saw, quite a number of them got pretty deep in the tournament as well. So yeah, I've certainly learned some new names from it.
Yes, no, a few of them. There was I was talking to the bookie just now, and he had them at $81 to win the tournament, and he was a little bit nervous there after a few rounds, but he got out of it.
Now, this is in no way to throw you under the bus, Trav. It's just basically some questions about potential things that could happen in the tournament next year.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, do you plan on introducing satellites to, one, to generate more money into the prize pool? And number two, this tournament's getting out of control now when it comes to the amount of talent pool that's starting to come in here. We're going to see more international players, which means we're really going to be decreasing the number of novice entries that can be allowed to play in this comp. So I think a really good way to be able to open that up for the novice players is to have the satellites for them, so that they're going to pay for a $500 entry. It's going to cost them, say, $100 to enter.
Look, every year, questions get thrown up about how it can be done better and for the following year. And I do like to listen to all the feedback and criticisms and what we're doing right. It's good to hear what you're doing right. And every time we put it on, we try and do the best we can with what we've got. And this year we tipped over the 128 player mark, which was good for numbers and good for entry fees and prize money and that. A little bit challenging with the draw. Obviously there's more games, but we worked it out, we got through it. Introducing satellites, it's something to look at. It's something to look at, especially if it's going to keep growing like this. We simply don't have the time to really fill up a 256 draw. If we do that, maybe we've got to start looking at dropping it back to race to 8 or race to 9 or something. Lots of questions have been raised. How to do it again next year and how to improve and streamline. So
my personal thoughts just on the only real thing that I changed next year is when it comes down to the final four, the only thing I'd really change is the two guys that kept their double chance up to that point can't draw each other.
Well, listen, if you look at it like this, you may have a different perspective on it. The whole tournament is played. Everyone's got two lives to make the final four bracket. So regardless whether you need them or not, those two lives are there for your benefit to make the final four. And the whole tournament is set up to make that bracket. Once you're in that bracket, it's a draw. So it doesn't matter where you come from in the draw, the final four is drawn blind. A lot of people are, I guess the people that are criticising it online at the moment aren't aware of how it was going to work, and all of a sudden we get to a semi-final and they see us drawing names out of a hat. I mean, it's it's probably premature to criticise when you didn't really know. All the players here knew how it's going to work. The players going into it, I'm sure all four finalists knew when they got to that point. They knew there was going to be a draw. So
it's just to me, the only reason I brought it up was that it was, I guess, like a reward. Mm-hmm. Which brings me on to my second one. I know I only found out recently that the Western National did this at their tournament, but they included a retainer bonus for the guys that kept their double chance going into the final, for losing it when it gets down to the draw situation. Is that something you might think about looking at as well?
It's something I thought about this year, and obviously didn't do it. However, one of the bonuses in making it through the winner's side is you're the freshest. You're going into each match with the maximum amount of rest and preparation time. The guys coming through the loser's side are at a disadvantage because they've been out there so long. And it is a big effort to come through the loser's side. I mean, we've both been on the loser's side. It's a long road. But the system will be looked at. And to be honest, I have thought about maybe if the numbers are going to keep on increasing, maybe I've been thinking about doing an elimination format in the final 8 or 16. And I mean, that's going to eliminate a lot of rounds and buy me a lot of time. And when you've got a cutthroat top 16, it's actually a bit of it's a spectacle. So that's one of the ideas floating around my head at the moment. So,
as I said, by no means criticise the tournament. It's just more of a suggestion thing. And I can't fault the way the tournament's been run, not just over the course this weekend, but the entire lead up onto it, the Facebook updates, the professionalism. Everything's run to time. Yes, we had some 5 a.m. finishes, but everybody knew that was going to happen and they didn't have to play the next day.
Yep.
Everything in my eyes was run perfectly. You couldn't really ask for more, Trav. And just to move away from that now, we've got two finals to play now. Oh, obviously, we've had the addition of the ladies as well, which is a fantastic idea.
Mm-hmm.
I personally thought the two that are in the final would make the final, but I want your predictions and scores for both finals.
Predictions and score. Okay.
Put you on the spot, mate.
Yeah, all four finalists are definitely worthy finalists. And look, after watching the ladies play, I think Lyndall is probably, she's travelling quite nicely, and I think Lyndall 8-5, if she continues the way she's going. And in the men's, I think the fact that Rusty knows he's not playing Mick is just going to fill himself up with confidence. And but in saying that, it should be an absolute ripper. I think Rusty 11-8.
11-8. All right. And anything else you want to plug the tournament for while we've got you here, Trav?
Oh, look, it's just been fantastic. There's so many people have commented positively, both online and personally, to both Melissa and myself for running the event and how we go about things. And no, look, we are trying hard, but it's a lot of work goes into it, and it's you know, we've missed a few things from here to there, and you know, I'm sure there's people I've forgotten to even get back to on questions and that. But we appreciate the support we're getting, and especially the numbers we've got to the event this year, 142 men and 37 women. We had 11 women pull out late. We did have a full field of 48, but there are different reasons that those ladies had, and it's, we move forward. It's been a fantastic tournament. We're finally at the end. We're about to witness two fantastic finals, and looking forward to it.
Oh, thanks very much, Trav. I'll let you kick things off now on the finals, and we'll get over there and talk some more rubbish.
Right. Thanks, Jamie. And thanks, by the way, thank you for your efforts in the commentating booth.
I love it.
It's been fantastic. So,
it's been great.
All right, appreciate it.
Thanks very much.
All right, thanks. Thank you.
Thank you.